Do 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 do. Oh yeah. Let's see if anyone's awake. I'm just going to bed myself. I thought I'd come on and see if anyone's about. Have a spliff with ya. Have a coffee. Read some comments. See what's been going on in the world. What's been going on? Well, I'm going to have to set this up though. So bear with me. Please bear with me. Let's see if we can make this work. Hopefully it'll work. I've got to try and get the headphones all the way over there. How am I going to do this? How will I do this? What am I doing? What are you doing? I don't know what I'm doing. Well, cut that off, take that off. Bring him over. Yeah, I'm on my way. I'm just sorting things out here. I've got to put your comments on the telly, anyway, because otherwise I ain't going to be able to see shit. I've been talking to my fucking self again, as usual. Seems to do that a lot lately. First sign of madness. It says live on there, it says good morning. Morning, brother. Let's have a look, see if anyone's awake. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear. I can't see any comments. I don't think there's anyone about. Is anyone watching? Don't look like it. Live. Good morning. 30 watching, is that right? I ain't got a fucking clue what's going on here. I really am trying. I really am. Right, is that the one? VHTV Plus. Oh, we're gonna have to get rid of the Plus, aren't we? You know what I mean? Can't have that anymore. Fucking hell. Hang on, 1 second. I just gotta make an adjustment here. Yeah! Maybe I'll let her plug the phone in and read the comments then, because I can't see any comments on this. Why is it doing that? How'd you get it? So live, what, just got to the last bit then? Right. I can't see none of your comments, yeah? So I'm going to make a coffee, and I'm going to sit down, and we're going to have a fag, and that's how it's going to go down. But you just had to give me a couple of minutes, yeah? Because I weren't going to broadcast. I wasn't going to. But I will for a minute till my batteries run out. Okay then. We'll do that, yeah? Okay then. Merry Christmas, by the way. Fucking freezing. I have no kitchen. It's not good at the minute. Fucking what am I doing? Right, I want to plug my phone in. Let me just do that. Look at me thinking I'm about to read my comments off my phone. Fucking eyesight's terrible lately. Okay, that's it we got here. Put this on charge. Well, I can't see any fucking comments. Okay. Yeah. That's a game. How are you? Morning. So let me just go in here and have a look and see. God, it's a lot of bloody words, isn't it, Brian? There's too many words here, Brian. Too many. Right, how am I doing? Let's go over here. Oh, fuck off, that power lead's getting on my tits now. Right, it reckons live.
Let's go over here.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck off, that
says live. Says live. Oh shit. Right, hold on. New pin chat. Yeah, got it. Live chat. Here we go. Live chat. What are we on? Live chat or top chat? How'd you fucking change that? No, I think live chat and top chat is all the same. Yes, what's happening? Billy Shears. Mark Bryden. Big up yourself. Paul Adams. Joey. Sonny Jimmy. Gavin Prince, Darren Smith, morning Brian, all good mate, yeah all good, thank you. Top Cat, good morning. Joanne Kirtley, good morning, good morning. Hello there, how are you? How are you? How are you? Good morning, good morning. 80 people, fucking hell, that was quick. And there's me thinking there was no one there. I didn't think you cared. But you do really, don't you? We're just bored. Rise up, Brian, rise up, rise up. Yeah, morning, 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 morning. We're here, mate, we're here. Thank you, McManus Gaming. Thank you very much. I can see that now. Good morning. Yeah, bloody hell, man. I've just come on. I can't even get through all of these comments. My God. How are you? I'm good, thank you. How are you? How are you? How are you? How are you? Good, oh, no, good, thank you. Hope you're well. You know, weren't planned type thing. It wasn't planned. Okay, the comments are stopped now. All right, we've got 64 watching. So, you know, fucking 16 people have run away. Come back, come back. The plus sign doesn't mean paedophile. It really doesn't. BHTV plus. I had a plus there, right, because like, I had 8 channels, didn't I? BHTV 1 to 8. And not anymore. So what I've done was I created another channel, which was BHTV plus. You know, like a bit like when you have, fucking E4 plus 1. You know, so I thought I'd do something like that. But just recently, I've been hearing about the LGBTQ plus. And I'm going to have to get rid of it off of there. Get rid of it. It's got to go, it's got to go. Brian, make a new Christmas number one. Yeah, because it's that easy. Thanks for that advice. I wonder where I've been going wrong. You sound really happy. I'm a bloody good liar. Yeah, inside I'm hurting. I'm dying inside. Yes, how's it going? Good morning, good morning. Good morning, good morning. Yeah, all right. Now we've got 67 in, that's not bad, is it? What's the time? Coming up to 20 past 6 in the fucking morning. Here we are. Here we are, just for you, London. Just for you and the rest of the world. Yeah, you can see I've come unprepared. Living the dream, says Ian Jones. I'm living the fucking dream. That's right. That's right. Just so, Brian, you have the X Factor in you, G. Thank you, G. Thank you. Toffee girl, Merry Christmas. All Merry Christmas. But is it? You know, that's what we ask ourselves. Whilst we sit here, alone, cold. Desperate. in solitude, I'm gonna make a coffee because I'm just talking pure fucking shit. Gotta wash me cup. I'll be back in a minute. I will be back. I'll come back and talk to you. We shall find something to talk about together as one. Just give me 2 seconds to rinse this cup out. I ain't got my BHTV cup there, Dave, and I'm not pushing up subliminals by using a Starbucks cup. It's just bigger, I can get more coffee in it. Saves me getting up and having to make another one. So, I don't work for the devil, and this is not his cup, okay? Okay then. Well, let's just get a... Let me just get myself a ready-made cappuccino. You know, I like a cappuccino, don't you? Early in the morning, cappuccino. Fucking hell. I've got an electric blanket on my bed. Can't wait to get in that. It's fucking roasting in the bed. Absolutely roasting. I'll be with you in a second, we will talk. talk. I was debating whether to, should I go live, shouldn't I? I ain't really got anything to say. I feel like, what's the fucking point when you ain't got nothing to say? But sometimes it's nice to just come on and see you all. Yeah. Cause it's good, like, you know what I mean? You're always about, aren't you, you lot? So it's good. Good times. Love the fire. Thank you. It's no, they fucking don't work. Nothing coming out of it. It just looks good. You know. So it is. Just bloody looks good. It's all lights, really. It's all fake, smoke and mirrors. It's all a lie.
On the show, Ian Ponick.
I'm sorry about this. I really am. I'll be with you in just a sec.
On the show, Ian Ponick, our first citizen activist. Ian Ponick.
I'm gonna light a candle for you. Candle for our love. Yeah, I just thought that. Yeah, what do you think? I think so, didn't you? Yeah, I do. Yeah, you know, that's fucking art, that is. That's real fucking art. There's my headphones. Yeah, I put the headphones on and it just come back into all the atmosphere. Yeah, there's bloody atmosphere in here. And why aren't your comments coming up on the fucking screen? Coffee and smoke, breakfast of champions, says Joanne Kirtley. Kirtley? Fuck yeah, Spaghetti's, yeah. Specsavers, hello Brian, you was my favourite band member. What, back when we was alive? Thank you. It's Christmas, Briar. Get the white coat and the fur hood on, mate. Do you know what I nearly did? And it wasn't out of entertainment. It was gonna be out of warmth. But then Nikki came along with an electric blanket and everything's good again. I shouldn't come on really when I haven't got anything to say. But I have, so there you go. I hope you're all good. As it's swinging our kid, it's swinging all right, our kid. Oh, this is good. Yeah, we'll leave it like that. Good morning. You got up at what? You got up at 5? Cockney Connection morning. Oh, shit. Got up at 5. Fucking hell, I ain't been down yet, man. And you're up. Fucking hell, Lee. What, you've just got up? You've just got up? Oh, fuck, I'm back to front. I hate being back to front now. It's fucking dark when you go to sleep, but it's fucking dark when you get up. Anyway, how's it going? How's it going, my Balenciagians? Yeah, I've been watching it all. I've been watching it. Yeah, fucking hell, Lee. You ain't gonna last. You'll be back to sleep by fucking 11 o'clock. Oh, I fell asleep, bro. I woke up fucking 8:45 at night. But I don't wish it upon you. I hope it works out. But yeah. That's not mine, fuck, promote that. Don't promote that. Oh, nice one, Lee. Well, I ain't been to bed yet. It's fucking bored, really, you know? It's boring. Just sitting here, thinking to myself, you know? What can I do about all this trouble that I'm in? Fuck all, really. You know, it's not, you're in it now, aren't you? It's too late. They're all after me. The royals are after me. Rupert Murdoch's after me. The news of the world are phone tapping me just in case I say something and they can get me. I'm coming and get ya. Like Sweden. Mr. Sweeting at the door there from the NCA. He's got an OBE. He's coming for me. Merry Christmas, Puddick, you fucking lying cunt. Merry Christmas. Merry. Fuck did they call it? Merry Christmas to you all. As we're about to go into our ritual pagan holiday, where children used to be thrown into Moloch and Baal, as in Baal and Siaga. You know the one. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's all happening, isn't it? Art is fraught with danger. Anyone seen what I put up about the picture? Prince Andrew, Virginia Giuffre, year ago, 2 years ago. You know, when I was saying it was fake. It's fake. I told ya. No one fucking listens to me, though. No celebrating Christmas. No, it's bollocks, isn't it? He weren't born on Christmas. They say the 6 month. It's June. Isn't it? It's not fucking December the 25th. Outside in a manger with donkeys in this weather. Travelling in this weather. I doubt it very much. They'd have been travelling in this weather. No, it's all lies, I'm afraid. All lies. Our governments, our nations, all lying to us. No, all it is a rinse up every year on the dot to rinse you of your bloody money. As if you ain't, you know, not got enough of it as it is. No, we have a plan. We'll Black Friday, based upon racism and slavery, but we're gonna use it anyway, Black Friday. It was like, oh, Black Friday's coming, Black Friday. Don't worry about where it comes from, what it means. Yeah, don't worry about that. No, I've got a cheap DVD player and a DVD. Does anyone use DVDs anymore? I got a cheap flat screen, plasma. Yeah. I don't know, I'm talking shit. Jesus is the way. And you'd be right in saying that as well. There is no other way. Yeah, I'm sorry. Like, I respect all your other religions, but I'm sorry, there ain't another way. And that's my fucking opinion. And I think I'm right. There is no other way. It is the only way, because it's the easiest one to put down where nothing happens. You don't get groups of people saying, we're gonna end you. If you said something about Jesus, they just go, you know what I mean? Nothing happens until close your eyes for the last time. Then and only then will it all become real. And you'll be going, Jesus, please help me. And you'll be going, no, I won't help you. You slagged me off, remember? Can't do it, I'm afraid. I can't see you. Who's that calling me? You know? You don't want that. You don't want that. So, how do we feel about the Balenciaga scandal? Stroke Adidas, and you know, ever since you started using a bloody pyramid, yeah, it's all gone wrong for you. Yep, that's what happens when you start throwing up Baphomets and pyramids, it all comes crashing down. And yeah, I've looked into Kanye West, and I think I was right with what I said initially. Don't trust him. Never liked him. I couldn't tell you what his fucking songs were called. I remember that one with Jamie Foxx in it. That's the only one that sticks in my head. Never got the hype. But now he's running around talking about God an awful lot. And Jesus is king. And he's right, but he don't mean it. Because if you meant it, Kanye, you wouldn't have let him kill your mum. and that's just me being real. It's all very well shouting and screaming about it now afterwards, but even that ain't real. You're a fucking plant, mate. You can fucking do one. Your soul's gone. You sold your soul, if I remember rightly. And it, at least it was like a McDonald's Happy Meal, because it came with some toys and a dead mum. So I ain't falling for your shit. And the fact that you're in with Trump, you know, there's pictures of Trump all over the Illuminati cards from 1994. Same year I went to the fucking Red Rooms with Daniela, yeah, to be precise. He's all over them. Charismatic leader. Blonde fucking gingery hair, geezer from the back with a coat on. Picture of Trump's face on the card that says, enough is enough. Like, fuck off. Fuck off. Fuck off. Just fuck off. All they do is fucking make up and paint fucking shitty stories. Just loads of shit, and they're all in on it. You know, President Trump. Who do you think Q was?
Well, no, I'm gonna tweet myself.
You know, it's fucking ridiculous. All of it. All of it. Fucking all of it. They're all nonsense, yeah? All nonsense. All fucking nonsense. When you're gonna get it in your head, they're all fucking nonsense that run your life. Yeah? Get it in your head. You're mad, Brian. You're mad. Your career's gone bad, hasn't it? You're bloody mad now. Yes, if you like. No, you are. You're bloody mad, you are. Go on, keep taking the meds, Brian. Fuck off. Just fuck off. You can take your bloody Christmas. You can fuck off. Fucking Christmas. Fucking Yule log. I used to fucking burn children on a Yule log. I know, let's get a lovely chocolate one this year. Ugh. I give up, mate. I give up. I give up, man. We got, you know, we got some alright people on here that come on here and, you know, all, we all seem to be on the same page on here. It's just the rest of the world. You know, how are we going to tell them? Oh, we've just lost Jamie Sawyer. Later, peeps. Lives matter, what? He's off. He must have, he's working. He's a working man. He's got to go. So frustrating that the majority still don't see it. Yeah, they're fucking idiots, aren't they? Eh? Idiots. Nice to see you again, Ellen. Even though I can't really see you, I can see your badge. Yeah. Yeah, well, what can you do, innit? You can only tell them, you can only tell people, you can only show them, you can only show them evidence. You can only show them. You can take the arse to the water, but you can't make it fucking drink, innit? They enjoy their servitude. Yeah, load of bollocks. Someone waving out a window at you like that. Oh, I'm better than you. Cunt, fuck off. You can't even plant a tree. Fuck off. Who are you? Fuck off. Mug. There's no point trying to reason with them. They're cunts. How can you reason with a nonce cunt? You can't. That's why they won't bloody listen. Nonce cunt. So I've not had my fingers down my pants. Brian, you're an absolute legend. Love you. Oh, thank you, mate. Love you too. Not in a gay way. They're not human. Get on Charlie Veach. He's doing their work in Manchester Daily. No. He's another plant. Don't trust him. Never trusted him. Never trusted him. Love my dressing gown. My dressing gown loves you. Hold on. Hold on, dude. Hold on to what? What should I hold on to, Daniel? My sanity. It's nice to see you all, even though I can't see you. I can see your words. Wednesday Kennedy. Are we all? Yeah, it's I ain't got fuck all to say. I really ain't. And I'm not even making an attempt to like get on one. I can't be fucked. Yeah, I've done, it's all I've done for 10 years is make these fucking videos. Yeah, pointing out everyone's wrongs, but it don't matter. It only matters if I do something wrong. Then and only then will it be world news. When you do something wrong, they're cunts and they fuck off. Just fuck off. Just fuck off. Just fuck off. Fucking red rooms. Just fuck off. Good for you, Brian. Chillax, man. Are you managing to keep warm, Brian? Yeah, just about. I'm like the rest of you. You've really been feeling it just recently, haven't you? It's been building up for the past couple of weeks, really, but just recently, yeah, I'd say we're moving into that icy air, you know, fucking, like, if you've got no heating on, wake up in the bedroom, ice cube, man, it's like a fucking ice cube. What is a red room? A red room's where they go to kill fucking children. Yeah, watch some videos. -1 this morning. Yeah, that, listen, they won't be happy until we're all starving, we're all fucking half dead, can't keep warm, unhealthy cunts, and they're all fucking hanging out the back of our children. That is their perfect world. Yeah, that's their perfect world. That's what we got coming. That's what we got to look forward to. Wicked. I love life. Yeah, it's bungle, isn't it? I mean, we could be on the verge of some sort of a breakthrough. You know what I mean? Hopefully if this Balenciaga thing carries on and carries on. But then we had all this with Wayfair, didn't we, a little while back, yeah? Wayfair's still running. I'm really sorry, slap on the wrist. It's all over now. No one's questioning Wayfair. It's not all over the internet. This one will probably pass as well. No doubt. I know it don't feel like, oh, Balenciaga, no, they're fucking ruined. Yeah, watch them try and make a sneaky comeback later on. Oh, do you remember us? We bought out a lovely top. You know what I mean? Fucking Nicky Cooper was right about that. What's the fucking clothing range? Camilla Batman Jelly and all them lot, and there was clothing range there for kids, and it said things on it like, be nice when things get hard and shit like that. They've took that clothing range down now. Free to be kids, wasn't it? Free to be kids. Yeah, I think they've took down some of that shit. I think that's got to be where Nicky Cooper was talking about it. I mean, why would you put shit like that on fucking kids' clothes? It's like that play that we got shut down a little while ago. Do you remember? A sex play. Yeah, bring your adults, bring your dog, bring your caretaker. Let's all get fucking naked. Yeah, man, we got all complained, didn't we? We got that thing fucking moved, mate. Get off, cancelled. Get out, you fucking nonce cunt. They keep trying it, don't they? They've been pushing it in art for a long time. You know. And Balenciaga, you know, the fashion and the art world, it's all one in the fucking same. It's still got wonky fucking cunts that have got Chanel guillotines and, you know, fucking body parts laying about. They're wonky, man. When did this happen? When did this era happen where they started drinking children's blood and doing all this mad shit? Or is it just the internet? Because I've not ever seen that, but I'm reckon it, I'm pretty sure it fucking goes on. Fucking 100% sure it goes on. But no one ever offered me a glass. Oh, could you drink someone's blood? Fuck no. Mm-mm. If I see someone do that, I'd have to say, you skanky cunt. You just drank that person's blood, mate. You done a, you cunt. Come back. It's disgusting, isn't it? You mean it does anything to people? You hear about it? Oh, adrenochrome. Does it? Fucking disgusting. Goes back to the Egyptians' blood sacrifice. Yeah, Moloch, all the rest of it, Baal. We've probably drank human blood without knowing through our lives as how sick these people are. Well, they've done it in the McDonald's, haven't they? They put me off for a while. But I've got to be honest, I've been having their cheeseburgers again. Because they're fucking easy to eat and they're a bit good. And you sort of think like, well, but it has been in the media about human meat in McDonald's. Of course they've done it to us. They're sick bastards. They've done it to us. What, through big food chains and that, Sainsbury's, Tesco's, how the fuck would we know when it's all minced up and that? You wouldn't, would you, I suppose? Yeah. Fucking disgusting. I can't even eat a fucking bit of meat when it's rare, man, let alone fucking, oh yeah, guess that, look, what? You cunt, you dirty cunt. Filth, innit, what this world's become. It's only getting worse as well. It's gonna get worse, less money, less heating, colder, more raping of children going on. And the big plus sign on the LGBTQ plus. Fuck off. Fuck off. Tiptoeing towards it all, weren't they? Like what David Icke said, tiptoe totalitarian, do the tiptoe totalitarian. Tiptoe towards it. So, in my books, I talk about the same old stuff forever, and people are still having it. So, Merry Christmas, everybody. Merry Christmas. What a joke, isn't it, eh? Fancy a bacon sandwich now. What do you fucking say that for? Why have you said that? Why have you done that? Why have you made me think about food now? Why have you done that? Oh, fucking hell. Yeah, do this regular, Brian. It's brill. It's brill. Thank you. Thank you, mate. Oh my God, I love your David Icke impression. In my books, I talk about Bill Maloney. What the hell is Maloney playing at? David Icke, he's going to be your saviour. Staring at a mound, hot Peruvian sun beating down. My arms go out at 45 degrees. Make no decision to do so. He's got his hair pushed back now. David. books and then. So, in my books, Sean, in my books, I talk about Babylonian, Sumerian, bloodlines, Sean. Morning from Glasgow. Good morning to you, Glasgow. David Ikea, I'd love to help you, but my hands were at a 45 degree angle and love to help you with your new flat pack wardrobe, but I can't because I've got to go. Time to fly. So, drinks on your head. Just having a bit of Jungle Boys. Just get in. How's the dogs, Brian and Jasper? Dogs and Jasper are all good, actually. All good. Their dogs are in the kennel. They got a heater in there. They're all right. Don't worry about them. They're the ones with the fucking heating. So, yeah, they're all right. They're in the kennel. And I've got a little bit more to do at the kennel soon, actually. I was going to go live when I do it. I've got to cut the carpet bits out, carpet the inside of it, and finish off with a little £95 hang-up TV in there. It's going to be good. I want it to be comfortable. I want it to be perfect for all year round. And if I have any more puppies, you know what I mean, it's sorted in there. I can have a dog channel on, I can have a bit of music in the background. They can watch me when I go live. They can watch all the old episodes, all of them back to back. Love it. Hear my voice in your dreams, when you're asleep, Trigger. So yeah, they're good. Don't bogart the joint, pass it through the screen once you've lit it up. Well, one day we'll be able to do that, won't we? We're like, yeah, okay, there you go, mate. I'm just putting in now. Boop, send. And you'll go, I've opened my email. Yeah, wicked. Yeah. I'm going to get nicked. It's like, we see your transfer, your Wii transfer. We're sending police to you now. No, right now. Open the door. Doom, 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 doom. Open the door. Yeah. Let's say you get caught and that. You've been fined 400 credits for sending illegal substances to Puff Pass. Fucking joking. No one fucking does that anymore, do they? Brian, you were almost as big as Take That, but you threw it all away to smoke bud. God, you're so right. Yeah, I was nearly there, nearly. Bloody hell, how far did you get? What? You didn't do anything. Oh, how dare you say anything? How dare you? Yeah, gave it all up for weed. Dee 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 dee. Better off now. Not looking, no one wants to bum me now. No one's trying to buy my bum anymore, which is a blessing. Your bum's not being sold behind your back anymore, Brian, and you don't have to watch your back no more. Oh, what the fuck's happening now? Oh, sorry. Don't worry. Don't worry. Please don't worry. Puddick. Puddick's easy, he just goes, I'm very lucky, I've got two jobs. We have a leak detection company. A team of experts go out and find leaks on things. My second job, Work for the Queen. Fucking Queen. Yeah. My second job. Fucking work for the Queen. Yeah, she's dead. Now what? Charles? Savile. Did I say that? Did I say that?
When somebody can ask him about Savile.
I was gonna, yes, pebble dashing. You got yourself. E17, always better than TT. Table tennis. Remember seeing you at Newcastle City Hall in about 93. Fucking hell. Glad you didn't remember, I can't. I don't remember much. Nope, didn't remember much. Yeah, that's because your eyes out of your face, Brian, you know. You'd have been as big as Tank that if you ain't gonna fucking smoke weed and took drugs. Hey, fuck off. That's not your fault. It's funny, always something I've fucking done wrong, isn't there? There's always something, you know? You're just wrong. You're wrong. I know you tried. No, you're bloody wrong. You're just wrong. Don't try. It's just gonna be wrong. True voice of E17. Thank you, Nutty. Yeah. Okay, I can live with that. I know you are. Right, take that. Didn't take drugs. Of course they did. One love, Hassan. Yes, Hassan. Big up yourself. I'd rather be smoking bud than be Gary Bart. Oh, I love biscotti. Oh, I guess now it's time. For me, skin up. I feel it's time. In the corner of my mind, I really want some heroin. Oh y'all, oh y'all. Yeah, good to see you back too. Never heard of it before. Oh yeah. Dun 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 dun. Motherfucking yeah. They just don't care no more. I just don't care. Rebel. Yeah. Oh, first citizen activist, Ian Puddick. Some funny characters out there, aren't there? Sorry about that. Ah, we love you because you're so naughty, naughty. So naughty. I've seen you smoke weed, mix. I've seen you. Yeah, that's why we like you.
So.
Derek. Fuck 'em, that's what I'll say. You don't run my life. No, you don't. I don't want to be in your bloody charts. Fuck your charts. Fuck your charts. Stick your charts in your nan's tits. Yeah? Stick your charts in your nan's pissy tits. What do I think of Kanye West on Alex Jones? It's a bloody good question. I think they're taking the fucking piss. And, It's obviously all inside fucking No different to Bill Maloney and Andrew Ashton, there you go. It's the same sort of shit, it's all planned. You know, Kanye's gonna run for president. He's got Trump backing him, right? You know, the biggest fucking turnaround to be, oh God, Kanye's president, fucking hell. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? But don't rule it out. Don't rule it out, yeah? But I will say, yeah, of course Kanye's a plant. Look, I can't make it any clearer than, they killed your mum. Yeah, right? They killed your mum, and then you went along with all the billions and millions from Adidas and Balenciaga and all that, yeah? Right, well, she's dead, and you took the money. So the bit where you're trying to talk about God now and Jesus is king, yeah, you're right, but you can't be saying that. And you're gonna get caught anyway and mugged off. It ain't gonna work out for you, I guarantee you. You don't get to do that. That's why I thought that was so obvious anyway. Like, and why ain't anyone else pointing it out? Kanye, you don't get to do that, mate. You took the Happy Meal, remember? Came with a few toys, remember? Right, they killed your mum. You can't go back, you know, it's not happening. But your soul's fucked, mate. I would not want to be you for all that Balenciaga money, all the billions and that they give you. I fucking wouldn't want it, mate. You let them kill your mum so you can have a few quid. You shit cunt, yeah? Drop dead, yeah? Drop dead, you fucking mad nutcase. Out there causing trouble. You're just causing trouble, mate. I ain't got no respect for him. Fuck him. Fuck him with the highest fuck he can have. Alex Jones was Bill Hicks. Nah, he's fucking rubbish, mate. He ain't Bill Hicks. He's not Bill Hicks, man. He's not. He's not Bill Hicks. Fucking not. Fucking hell. Yeah. No, I think he's a shit cunt. Because you let him kill your mum. So you're fucked, mate. There's nothing you can say, nothing you can do. You might as well ride it out with Trump and them lot, because you're fucked, mate, when you die. You're fucked. Nothing's going to save you. Nothing. If you can let them kill your mum for a few quid so you can look good in front of your mates, I'm pretty sure that ain't going to go down well on the other side. So yeah, you get on with it, mate. You're a shit cunt. Keep trying to fucking, you know what I mean, rope everyone in into like, listen, you know, all the black people would love someone true up there to believe in, but Kanye is not the fucking one, right? He ain't the truther. He took the money, yeah? He took the money, yeah? At a time when, you know, all this stuff's been going on for ages, all this Illuminati stuff and all the rest of it. It's been out there ages before he came along. You know what I mean? So his soul's fucked, mate. He knew what he was getting into. And you've had the money, and now he's not even fucked. Yeah? He's not even fucked. They are playing games. Yeah? The next believable person, like they've done it to you with Obama. I said this back then. I look at them putting a black guy in there now. And black people lost their minds. They couldn't believe it, because yeah, first black president and all that. I get that. But fucking, he ain't the one either. They're all wrong-uns, these people they keep putting in. And they will put in someone that's cut their cock off next. You know what I mean? So you all do it. They will. They're fucked, mate. They've lost their mind. Yeah? Hollywood, America. You got Biden as your fucking president. The cunt that was going around sniffing all the kids' hair. Are you fucking out of your nut? Seriously? What, you voted for that cunt? Are you fucking serious? He can't even go fucking do a speech. Can't read an auto cue. But he's all right sniffing. Oh, I fucking like you. He's a cunt, isn't he? He's a cunt. Nah. He's a cunt. Yeah? He's a cunt. Like the people we've been having in power. Cunts. Yeah? And the next one they'll have lined up for us. Cunt. Yeah? Cunt, cunt after cunt after cunt. When are we gonna get rid of these cunts? Yeah? You keep having them. They keep coming along, like, yeah? telling you things are going to change, they get worse. Cunt, another cunt, yeah? Let's get Theresa May out. Come on, Theresa. Do, 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 you robot. Fuck off, you shit cunt. Now you've gone and made everyone think we're like you. What a cunt. Hey, ain't you fed up with these wonky, inbred, frumpy, stupid, fucking pompous, posh, fucking twits running the place? Fucking lying blonde cunt having a party, you was. Fuck you and your dad and go fuck your nan's tits, you shit cunt. Fucking. I could have told you years ago he was a fucking idiot. Fucking idiot. Fucking idiot. They've all been fucking idiots. They've all been lying to you. Newspapers, phone tapping, setting people up, fucking people's kids, supplying them to higher ups. Shit cunts, mate. Police, shit cunts. Fucking shit cunts. Never been honest in their fucking life. Yeah, ever. Shit cunts, yeah? They all need getting rid, yeah? All of them. Yeah, nothing's gonna change if you keep these fucking same shit cunts in fucking power. Keep voting for them. Oh, let's have Labour next. Keir Starmer. Oh, Mr. Speaker! Fuck off, you fucking twit cunt. Just because you used to be Director of Public Prosecution, Prime Minister! Fucking cunt. Can't stand these fucking cunts. Look at them all lined up when it goes into Parliament, all sat there. Fucking mugs. How do you expect things to get fucking better? You know what I mean? With fucking cunts like that. Fucking shit cunts. I don't care anyway. Fucking whatever. Eaton, yeah, that's it. Eaton. Fucking Eaton. Fucking Eaton. Fucking cocksuckers. Fucking cocksuckers, mate. Fucking Eaton. I've been eating cock from cunt. Can't stand them. Fuck off and die. Home Office. Fucking Home Office. Leon Britton. Fucking Leon fucking Britton. Fucking nonce cunt. Fucking nonce. Nonce. Dirty nonce cunt. Fucking Jack Straw. Home Office. His brother was a nonce. Been dumped with it twice. Fucking nonce cunt. But no one says nothing. No one cares. No one cares. No one cares. Gary Hotchkiss. Out of the Home Office. Fucking cunt was 7 foot with a nice car. Drove 150 miles up north to go and meet a 12-year-old. Fucking Home Office. Shit cunt. Yeah? Shit cunt. All shit cunts. Fucking lot of them. Yeah, put me in number 10. I'll fucking do it. No, I've actually, fuck that. I don't want that job. I ain't Kanye West. Fuck that. Fuck that. I'd just like to see them all get dragged out of there, beat up in the fucking street, trod on their fucking faces and say, how do you like that, you shit cunt? Yeah? And then we put people in all the establishments that we can trust, that we vote in, real people. We go, actually, you've got good ideas. Yeah? I like what he's saying. But actually, for real, not you can have Labour. Oh, Mr. Speaker! Or you can have fucking... Yeah, who's going to light you and have a party while you're all indoors? Like, I want to see my mum, but I can't. But like, party. Jeez, fuck off. You fucking shit cunt. You look like the cunt off the fucking Quaker Oats advert, you fucking shit cunt. Fucking, when these cunts all going to hurry up and die? I don't make fuck all on royalties, mate. I was hoping I was going to get something this fucking year, even if it was like 100 quid, 120 quid, something, you know what I mean? Normally about 88 quid, fucking 112 quid, shit. For 30 million fucking records. Nah, it's bollocks. It's all bollocks. Yes, Queen of Freedom, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yeah, man, all cunts, I'll give up. I'll give up trying. Fuck 'em. Fuck 'em. I ain't here to impress no one. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Innit? Fuck 'em. I ain't gonna try no more. Fuck it. You know what I mean? What's the point? What's the point? It's all out there. There's more to come when it all blows up. It's gonna, you ain't gonna escape this one. They're fucking child traffickers in this country, mate. That's what they are. That's why everyone goes, oh, shh, shh, no, don't say that, don't say that. No, you're fucking child trafficking, raping child, fucking raping cunts. You fucking cock licker. Fucking cunt. Fucking baby ass licker, you fucking dirtbag cunt. Dirtbags. Andrew Ash laughing on that tape bothers me. Have you seen more than one child killed? Well, yeah. Yeah. You fucking fat sloth cunt, jump up and down on your fucking head. You fucking piece of shit. Fucking stamp, stamp, stamp on your fucking head. You fucking piece of shit. I wish I'd have known these cunts were gonna go the way they went with it with me, yeah? Andrew Ash and these, I wish I'd have known that fucking night, mate. I'd have fucking knifed every fucking one of them. Fucking shit cunts. I would have fucking knifed you all in the night. You cunt. Andrew got scared because I took a knife to bed with me, yeah? I took a knife to bed with me. And he got Bill to come over. Oh, Bill, what you got a knife for? I said, what do you think I got a knife for? I said, look where we are. We're in holes. If that fucking door comes off in the middle of the night, I want half a chance, mate, yeah? But what's that for? I thought you didn't drink. Fucking shit cunt. If I'd have known what they was going to do, they'd have all got it that night in that cabin. I'd have fucking done a lot of them. I would have. If I'd have known that this was going to be the outcome of it. Cunt, mate, you'd have all got fucking stabbed up that night. Cunt. I don't know if Earl's in prison. He's a fucking lying cunt, mate, yeah? So fuck him, yeah? Don't ask me about him. He come round here for Puddick, winding me up, lying to me, took a load of details off my ex-girlfriend, then wants to go on the fucking internet talking shit, lying about me. Cunt, yeah? Fuck off. Don't fucking talk that person's name to me ever again. He took the fucking piss, mate. Fucking piss. Yeah? You took the fucking piss. But you want a fucking straightener, yeah? Come and knock on the fucking door then. You want a straightener? Come and fucking explain yourself, yeah? What you fucking done. Explain yourself. Fucking fed up with these shit cunts, man. You want to do something? You got something you want to fucking do? You know where I live? 187 St. John's Road, Walthamstow, London, E17. Come and get me. Come and get me, you fucking slags. Yeah? Come and get me. Because you're cunts, mate, a lot of you are. I can't fucking wait to expose you all, you fucking cunts. Drop dead. Fucking scared of you. Fuck you. Fuck you. You will need fucking stabbing in the temple, mate. Yeah, that is what you need. I'm not saying I'm going to do that. But that's what you fucking need, yeah? I got no respect, mate. No respect now. This world don't respect me. Fuck any cunt, mate. Fuck any of you, yeah? Fuck any of you that want to tell me anything. Fuck you. Don't tell me nothing. Don't tell me nothing ever again. Chill, Winston. Yeah, it's true though. Like, listen, fuck, I don't give a fuck, yeah? You know that now. I don't fucking care. Fuck Christmas. Fuck Puddick. Fuck the dead shit cunt queen. Fuck the royal family. Don't trust none of them, right? Don't trust fucking none of them. You, especially the boys now, you want to go along like that, right, yeah? They kill your mum and you want to walk about doing that shit. And walk about doing that shit, yeah? Mm. Fuck you, yeah? Fuck you. Fuck you. None of these cunts are right in the head, none of them. Get rid of the fucking lot of them, yeah? I'm sick of your fucking shitty royal games. You are the shit cunts in life. You're disgusting. You haven't set a good example. It's all a facade, yeah? You'd be nothing without the people around you ironing your fucking clothes and doing your makeup and wiping your fucking shitty asses. You're shit. And you could have done much better with your royalty. You could have done good things for people. But instead, you fucked children, yeah? You fucking evil shit cunts. I'll never stop until you're gone. I want you gone. I want you fucking gone. And every politician in that fucking shithouse parliament, I want every single one of you out of there. You want to talk about a reshuffle? Let's have a fucking life reshuffle. Let's take all the shit cunts out of them positions of power and put them all on fucking benefits. Right? Let's put them all on benefits. Then let's put real genuine people in all those positions of power. Just sit back and try it for 6 months and see what happens. Yeah. That's all. That's all. Good morning from Portugal. Hello, Portugal. Good to see you back. Yeah, I'm here. I never went nowhere. If only getting buttons from royalties, an American lawyer must be criminal. Ah, fuck them. Let them have their money. Like I said, innit? Well, Murdoch owes me about 20 million quid. It's not a joke. It's more than that, actually. Yeah? You owe me a fucking million for every year you've taken away. It's more than that now. All right? It's more than that now. But let's say it's 20 million, yeah? Geezer owes me 20 million. Shove it up your cunt. Shove it up your smelly fucking cancer bum. You fucking piece of shit, Murdoch. Another cunt. All that money, all that influence, all that power, what did you do? Nonce. You fucking nonce. Nonce. Power hungry, control, manipulative, nonce bag. Yeah? That's all you are. And anyone that's got their nose up your ass, they're the fucking same. You are dog shit. Dog shit, mate. Dog shit. And you want to judge me because I smoke a bit of weed and talk some truth? Fuck you, mate, yeah? Got more integrity in my fucking eyelash than all of you put together. You're all cunts. And the trick is to go, oh, actually, they're all cunts. Why do I listen to them? I'm not listening to you no more. I don't look to the police now and think, oh, yeah, you know, you're wankers. Wanker, wanker. Simon Werrett, wanker. Christian pastor, Digitally Simon, you're a fucking little wanker, mate. If I ever see you, I'll smash you in your fucking stupid little skinny face now. You used to be a fat cunt. What, you got AIDS? What, you got AIDS now? You fucking Christian pastor fucking shit cunt. Yeah? I thought you was a copper. How'd you become a pastor? We've been talking to Camilla Batman fucking Jelly, fucking Andrew Fatman fucking Jelly, fucking Batman fucking fat cunt. Yeah? Teach you how to be a fucking pastor. Cunt. Fucking wait till I see you. You can't care if you're exiled, but I'll smash you straight in your fucking face. You want to put me in prison, then run around like your fucking god lover? Yeah? Yeah? Do ya? Simon Werrett? Simon Werrett? DCI Simon Werrett? Ex fucking Essex fucking police? Fucking shit cunt? You're fucked anyway, mate. Everyone knows about you. Everyone knows about you. And why you got a load of African children wearing SRC on tops, yeah? Well, you're part of that SRC code, fucking... Oh, I know, I make myself look like a Christian pastor, make myself look really good while I'm a fucking child trafficker underneath. Shit cunt, yeah? Drop dead, you and your fucking shit cunt missus. Fucking both die, mate. Road accident, anything, whatever. Caught between two cars, smash. Fucking hate ya. Fucking hate ya. Fucking hate ya. God hates you as well. Yeah, especially where you're hiding behind the Christian thing. Yeah, God fucking hates you, mate. He can't wait to get his fucking hands on you when you close your eyes for the last time, you fucking sloth. Fuck you. Yeah. I can be angry and tidy. And you know what? I'm not a Jew, but I'll tell you what I'm seeing a lot. Jews are getting it at the minute, aren't they? This is all planned. This is all planned. Jews are getting it at the minute. Right, what you got to remember is the bad people are the Zionists. Just know that, man, because you know what I mean? You can't go around, that's like going around going, oh, all Muslims then, oh, you must all be fucking grooming gangs. Yeah, we might as well be doing that then. Yeah, because the Jews are not the Zionists. The Jews have had their shit nicked. They've had their shit nicked. Yeah, they've been hijacked. They've had their shit hijacked. You think they ain't fucking putting their own people up to die. How many people did die in Auschwitz, yeah? Ain't that them letting their own people die? So who's behind that? Who was the geezer that was rounding up his own people for the fucking Germans? Soros. George Soros. Yeah, what a sellout cunt that is. Ugly cunt as well though, let's face it. He looks like the fucking emperor. He's got all that under there and that. Fucking emperor, the cunt. Yeah, like seriously, because otherwise, because I'll tell you what's happening. You see this Kanye West thing, right? You're causing trouble. You're causing trouble. You can't go around and paint up everyone the same. You can't, right? I've said this before a million times. You've got shit cunts in every fucking race, yeah? Don't hide behind your religion so we can all go, you're having a go at me, I'm a Muslim and I'm a Jew. No, fuck off, you cunt, yeah? Don't give it all that. Don't give it all that. Don't give it all that, because that's the trap, you see. That's the trap. And that's what Kanye's laying out at the minute, yeah? It's a fucking trap. Don't fall for that cunt, yeah? There's nothing wrong with Jewish people. There's nothing wrong with Muslim people. There's nothing wrong with people in general. And you know this. You don't need me to tell you. I ain't going now. You don't need me to tell you, yeah? You don't. You don't even need it pointed out. You fucking know already. Yeah? But then some cunt like Puddy is the type of person who go, oh, he's having a go at Jews. You know, trying to use Tom Carhill to draw me in. So I end up going, yeah, all fucking Jews are the same. It's all your fucking fault. It ain't. Listen, I will say this, right? If they can be targeted, right? And, you know, if you killed 1,000 of them in a load of ovens and gassed them and that, even that's fucking wrong, right? Don't forget that. Imagine you was a certain race and people were like, yeah, we're gonna fucking get these lot. You know what I mean? And there was a history of it. And I'm not Jewish myself, you know what I mean? But just think about it from that point of view, because I don't think people do sometimes. And I'm fair, I'm in the middle, I'm just sitting here like, oh no, that ain't right, that ain't right. Right, what's right is right, and what's wrong is wrong. And I just think someone's trying to start something lately. You know, we're all the fucking same. So what if your belief to the higher power is different from mine? As long as you ain't a Satanist, I ain't got no time for a fucking Satanist, you can drop dead, mate, with everything that I've got. With everything that I've got. Satanist, fuck your mum. You probably have, if you're a Satanist. You probably have. You probably have. You probably have. But come on, man, don't be led astray by pricks. He's a prick, Kanye West. You're a fucking prick. You're up yourself. You think you're a god. You stupid, stupid cunt. Now fucking drop dead, man. You ain't worthy of life. Drop dead. Drop dead. Fucking drop dead, man. Drop dead. Drop dead. Fucking dog shit, mate. A lot of them. No one tells the truth. That's what I'm saying. Fuck your money. I'm just gonna talk truth, innit? It takes another 10 years, another 20 years. Mate, you know where I stand. Yeah, you know where I fucking stand. I know, because there is, you know, there is an obvious answer. Someone's right here and someone's wrong with their God. Obviously, we all think we're right, don't we? I think Christ is the only way. It makes sense to me because he's the one that everyone gives a kick into and it appears that nothing happens. But I guarantee you it does. It's just, that's part of the free will. Yeah, you can, you know, you can slag me off if you want. It's fine, it's up to you. But nothing ever happens to people when they slag off Christians. So that's the easy one to put the boot into. But they go so much out of their way to turn the Christianity on its head. And I can see for myself that why are they going out of their way to turn people away from that? If it's a load of fucking waffle when it ain't real, what are you worried about? What are you worried about? Why are you so hell-bent on turning people away from Christ and going this way? Someone knows something, yeah? I'm telling you now, play it safe. and believe in Christ. Right? Even if you're doing it for that purpose. Even if you're doing it for that purpose. Just go to Christ. It can't hurt, can it? Is it going to chat? Even if you don't believe anyway, is it going to change anything in your life if you don't believe? No. So what's the problem then? Just do it anyway. Because when you get on the back end of things, I think you're going to be glad you did. I'm sorry, but I think you will. But that's my belief. Then a Muslim will say, well, no, I don't agree with that. You know, I think that, yeah, Jesus was real. He was a prophet. I don't believe he was the son of God. And then there's contradictions in that. So, you know, does it really matter if someone else has got a different belief in God? I know we can stand about and argue about it on Speaker's Corner for fucking ever. But it don't change anything, does it? Even if one person proves a point over another. Everyone still fucking goes home at the end of the day and nothing changes, does it? So why don't we just all accept that we're all here and the only people that we need to go around and get rid of are paedophiles. Whatever race or religion you are, you just need to get it, yeah? Because you're taking the fucking piss. Ooh, we need to understand their minds and where they come from and you know, what makes them tick. And no, we don't. We need to kill them. They need to die. If you've raped a child, your fucking life goes. The end. There can be no middle ground. And it has to be proved beyond any fucking reasonable doubt. And you're put to death. That's the only way. We can't have these cunts in our society. Whether you're in positions of power or whether you're just a nothing, no one on the street with fuck all. We can't have that. We cannot have this fucking danger, this real danger to kids. And what's the government doing? Oh, we want to understand them. Why? Because the majority of them are paedophiles. It's not that fucking difficult. At all. It's not difficult at all. Not at all. Not at all. What is so fucking hard about that? Oh, it could never happen there. Yes, it fucking can. Because there's millions of us. And how many of them is there? What, 1,000? And call your police out and that. What, you think their police can cope with millions taking over London? And not smashing the place up. Be peaceful. Don't do nothing but just be there. I've said this before. But, yeah, no, I'm just a cunt. Don't worry about what, you know, I'm a fucking idiot. Well, don't listen to me. Don't listen to me. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm just a washed up pop star. I don't know what I'm on about. I don't know nothing. Not important. No, I know nothing. I'm an idiot. Don't listen to me. Shouldn't be here. What are you doing here? Go on. Off we go. Subscribers. Do. Go down. 142 people. Good morning. Yeah. No, it's, you know, what I mean? It's real shit. Real shit. But it's all stuff you already know. But yeah, we seem to get led. You know what I mean? Internet's doing it. It's the internet. It's 100 mile an hour, the internet. You wake up, you sit on the toilet, you have a shit, you're like, whoa, YouTube Shorts. And it take you for a million and one emotions before you've even wiped your fucking arse. Take you through a bit of sad music, fucking what's his name crying again? Oh, what was his name? Fucking Jordan Peterson. I like him, I can listen to him. Yeah, he's fucking always crying. Stop crying. All right, I get it. You're an emotional man. Get it. Just don't let it cry like that all the time. You know, you made your point. It's okay to cry in front of people. It's all right. I've done it. Don't fucking need to do it all the time, though. Stop crying. Yeah? Stop it. So you wake up, you'd be having a shit. He's already made you feel sad. Then it'll jump to someone doing a fucking dance. Then it'll at the bottom of a fucking escalator. Then it'll go on to some cunt making a fucking omelette and folding it over in a piece of bread. Right? And then there'll be fucking 50 Cent or someone talking about Jay-Z. Then Kanye will pop up, you know? And then it's something about COVID. And it's time you've got off the toilet, you're depressed. Fucking fuck my day up already. And they know this. They know this. They know this is doing this to people. It's just the internet. It's just, it's all too much. It's like overwhelmed. If you're into music, plugins, wake up every day, email, Waves Audio. Do you want this one? Do you want that one? Do you want that one? It's Black Friday, what about this one? If you can buy three, you can get this one. Fuck off. Fuck off. Fucking trying to sell me something all the time. Fucking subscribe. You know, fucking leave a comment. Fucking all the same from Uber and that. Oh, you know, it's not about fucking paying for the meal anymore. It's, well, have I got enough to fucking tip him? And fuck off. Leave me alone. Fuck's sake, man. 100 mile an hour. Good morning, Nikki, my beauty. There she is. There she is. I'm just on here having a moan. I didn't start off moaning. It's just gone that way, hasn't it, everyone? Hasn't it, 152? It's just gone that way. Dave West thinks it's funny. You know, he's got fucking tears coming out of his eyes. He loves it. I have to admit, days without mobile phones were better. Mate, I've got mushies on go to microdose. Have a look into it. Thank you, Brian, for your courage, Nathan. Thank you, Nathan, for your comment. Oh, by the way, Nikki has just posted up all my links, yeah? And on now, I've got an eBay, a few eBay bits up there, yeah? We've still got the Freddy Krueger outfit. It was a David Miller Creations mask and not the jumper now, though. I've kept the jumper. But there is an original Nightmare on Elm Street sweater there with it and the glove. It's proper. We got the prototype Back to the Future outfit, which is looking pretty fucking good, I've got to say. If anyone ever wanted a Back to the Future outfit that ain't quite as good as my one, but this was the first one, and I'll tell you what, it ain't fucking bad. You've got the proper original jeans in now. You've got the proper t-shirt. You've got the proper shirt. You've got the Air Mags. They were the Mark One, but they've had a couple of modifications to them. Mate, if that's what I had and I couldn't have got anything else, I'd have had to have gone with that, and it would have been all right. The jacket's a nice fit, although it's thin. We put the bits around the sleeve and around the waist. You've got a proper fitted hat. That's a proper one. You can't find them fitted. They come all the way from Australia, them caps. So it's a very good Marty McFly cosplay outfit. You know, so it's a very good one. So that's up for sale. And obviously selling these bits now is just sort of, well, obviously I still owe Nikki money, which is why I'm selling bits, just to get the debt paid and get back to zero. and then start again with lenses. There's more lenses that we need. And eventually we will get there and do this gig later on. It's something to work towards, isn't it? You know, it's been 30 years. I don't see why I shouldn't be able to put on an online concert. I don't see why not. Not unless anyone else wants to start being a problem and that, and if they do, I'll just fucking drop evidence and say, oh, bollocks, and have that. You know what I mean? So I can't see anyone getting in the way of it. I've sung the fucking song, so I've got a right to sing them, and I feel I can do a good job of it as well. So you know, obviously it ain't going to be this Christmas. It's not going to be this Christmas. I would like it to have been, but you know, if you ain't got all the stuff, you can't. So I need to get my kitchen sorted, which is what's happening at the minute, about to. Fucking shitloads of rubbish outside my house. Get all that cleared, get this sorted out and straight, and then I can fully concentrate on making you happy. I just want to make you happy. Yeah. Now, just having a laugh, innit? You know, fucking live life. Fuck Murdoch. I don't mean to say I ain't going to punish him still, but you can keep your money, because you're a shit cunt. I don't want your Zionist blood money. You can poke it up your fucking cancerous ass, you fucking cunt. And, yeah, that's how I feel about it. So fuck him, the nonce. Fuck Prince Andrew and Ghislaine cunt Ed Maxwell. Fuck you, you fucking shit cunts. We all know about ya. We all know what I've seen. And it will all come out. It will, because it's already out there, isn't it? So it's gonna go further. Because you ain't fucking doing this to me, yeah? You ain't doing this to me. And getting away with it, and I'll fucking die getting you back, mate, yeah? Just know that. So that's what these cameras, and that's what this is all about. So I suppose, really, I would like to just get tidied up in the kitchen, get the house sorted, and then I'm fucking going to war, mate, yeah? And these cameras are getting bought to fucking Downing Street, and we are going to have it with these people big time, and we're going to take it to fucking people's houses if we can find them, Bill Maloney. Yeah, John Wedger, all these people. And they're gonna be made to fucking answer the questions that they should have answered years ago. All of them. You're not getting away with it. You don't get to do that to a pop star. Set a pop star up, yeah? Try and put me away for fucking 18 years like you fake Carl Beach. Let's have a look at a picture of Carl Beach in prison. Let's have a look at a picture, right, of Ian Huntley in prison. Let's have a look at a picture of Sidney Cook in prison. Yeah? Let's have a look at a picture of Levi Belfield in prison. Yeah? They're not, are they? None of them. None of them. Good morning, Tony. Good morning. Follow me on Instagram. Brian Harvey, E17. I've got a fucking blue tick. Follow me. But I've got to keep it clean on now. Yeah, I've got to keep it clean. I can't see all this. I can't be doing this on there. Can't do this on there. Oh, you fucking can't. No, you can't. And eventually, you won't be able to do this on here either. So I say to you all now, go over to my website, which is there. We're not live on there yet, right? But the website's there, bhtv.uk. It couldn't be easier, bhtv.uk. Go over there and scroll down to the bottom and you'll see a bit where it wants your name and your email. That's how you subscribe to my site. If you can do that, that puts us in touch forever. So, you know, be part of helping me eventually one day getting up to like 1 million subscribers. Can you imagine that? You know, we should be able to do it. It's not like I haven't had enough exposure all through my whole entire life and sold enough records. I think, you know, we'll be able to get up to 1 million subscribers on there when I'm not being held back in the way that I am now. But yeah, we'll be able to do that. We'll be able to do that. And fuck me, can you imagine that? If I had 1 million subscribers behind me, I can just send you a fucking email all at once. And if we was to go and pull an event up London, Downing Street, or wherever, it would be so much fucking easier this way. Then, oh, I'm getting somewhere. Oh, I'm gonna take my channel down. You know what I mean? Until we all go to bhtv.uk. And that is a very good place. That's my home, yeah? That's what's gonna be my home. Whenever I go live in the future, as soon as we can sort out the bandwidth thing and what's going on there, we'll get sorted, because the site's built, it's there. We've got the fucking disclaimer and everything on there, you know? So, that's really what I should say to you, is go there. Go there, subscribe, and just bookmark it and keep it with the bhtv.uk that you've got bookmarked. Just keep it there. And also, you can get a thumbnail. You can get a thing for your phone. Look, see down there? Can you see that? But you can't, can you? This one here, BHTV. Come Yeah, it's my fucking site. That's my fucking site. It's my website. There it is. There it is. See that? So you can get that too. I forget how you do it now. But you can have a thumbnail on your phone. Just go boop, and there you are. And then look, accept me. Accept me into your life. And as you come down here, look, stay up to date. Name, last email, submit, and we're friends forever. Yeah. Yeah, we'll be friends forever. And then I can keep you informed later on when, because they love taking me down, they like doing it. I'm not even supposed to be live now on BHTV Plus. You all saw the screenshot that I took where I told you I've got a strike on the channel, and I ain't supposed to be able to go live until January 23rd. No one told me it had been lifted or whatever. What the fuck? You know? What is going on with you lot, YouTube? You know, you got to stop letting the intelligence services in your back door. You know? Got to stop it. Stop letting them in. It's against the fucking law. Yeah? You shouldn't be letting them. But they do. I'm also on Twitter. I don't really use it though. Good morning, Who the Funk. Morning, Brian. Can you do a little Ike impression to make my day, please, Sean? It's what the fuck? Who the fuck? Sean. Brian, you should get back on Twitter. I'd be at the mercy of Elon Musk and his muskiness. Good morning, Marvetto. How many subs do... Can't wait for a day out, Brain. Cheers, Hassan. Hey, Brain. Follow the boy on Instagram. Brian Harvey, 17. Also, I'm on TikTok. Yeah, just fucking find me, innit? I'm on there. Do you know how many subscribers I got on TikTok? 33.5k. Oh, there's that fucking number, 33. That's what I thought when I fucking got back into it. I've done it the other day. I was like, 33,500 subscribers. Some of the views on the video's got like fucking 400k. So like all the stuff when I was talking about Daniela and that. Yeah. Oh yeah, it fucking well got round. Yeah, wicked. Thank you for subbing to the website. Thank you very much. That's it. I mean, that's the way to get on in life. You know, it's all very well when that thumbs up on here and like and all that, but really, just go to bhtv.uk, go there, fill your name in, sub, done. Yeah, because I will be live from there in the future when the moment is right. Obviously, there's no point in doing it yet because there's fucking hardly anyone over there. You know, so get over there and subscribe, all right? Because I guarantee you things are going to get lively in the future. And when they get lively in the future, it means they'll be taking me down off of this fucking shit up. And I'll have to go live from there, but I'll have a base to do it to. And then when I do, I won't be, you know, talking to 50 people, hopefully. There'll be fucking, you know, the original 50,000 that was on BHTV. That was on BHTV 1, you know, we could do with all you coming back, really, you know, come back to us. Yes, nice one, thank you. You know, it don't cost you nothing, just go over there and sign up. And we can get it on, oh yeah, yes. Yeah, man. I love you all too. Thank you very, very much. It's good. It's good to have the support of people that are clued up and understand what I'm saying and agree. And you know, we all get each other, don't we? Yeah, we do. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. How long have I been on for? Fucking hell, it's 7:45. I was only coming on for half hour. Always happens though, doesn't it? These are the best times to go live, I think. Middle of the fucking night. It's the best time to do it. That's fucking cold. So yeah, I've got a few bits on eBay for sale. So if you want to help and you want to help the channel, that's the only way to help me, because I can't take fucking donations and Patreons and all that. And I'm not monetized on YouTube or anything like that. So the only way that you can help me is someone come in and fucking, you know, buy the bits that I've got up on eBay. That's my only legitimate way, you see. But yeah, there's a couple of good bits up on there. There are. You know, I've sold fucking lot of bits backwards and forwards through the years. And eBay's been really fucking handy. But they take the piss now, don't they? Like, they started doing all that invoicing a little while back. I think they stopped that because everyone thought, oh, fuck, you ain't using this no more. It's like getting a fucking invoice at the end. It's like, what? I just take the bit off and send me what's clear. What's all this longness? So, yeah, it's got a bit strange on there now. If you're a seller. If you're a fucking sellout. Some painting. You painting? All right, you painting. Let's get one of them sprayers. You get a Wagner sprayer. They're fucking blinding. Takes the sting out of painting, mate, I tell ya. Takes the sting out of painting. Get the small sprayer. I say small, there's a medium sized one. It's about 150 quid, something like that. You can get an extender pole in that as well. It's made by Wagner. Flexio 580. There you go. There's the actual fucking product number. So yeah, have a look at that. And you can pick them up for about 150 quid on eBay. And you will have the nicest time decorating. I recommend you go round and spray all of your wood first. So all your skirtings, all your door architraves, to, you know, seal off your windows and spray, or just fucking literally as quick as that. So it's fucking mad. And go round all your wood, leave it for 48 hours, then come round, tape it all off, and fucking blast off all your walls, pull the tape off, you're all cut in, done. I'll tell ya. And the finish is fucking brilliant. But don't get the really little small hand one, because I've done a room with that. I've done the green room upstairs, and it was good. It wasn't loads of overspray on it either. But if, you know, that's when you needed the next size up, and you'd have just been like, this is nothing. You know, fucking paint your room in 15 minutes, like, you'll love it, honestly. So, little tip for you there. Direct link to items, Nick has just put that up, thanks Nick. Are you in the middle of painting the room now? Well, Wagner sprayer, right? Flexio 580, right, about 150 quid, you won't regret it. I promise you. It will change your view of decorating. It's easy, it's enjoyable. You know, it's like jet washing. Everyone loves a fucking jet wash, don't they? Yeah. It's like jet washing your ass. It's not. I'm very tired. Good morning, Kenneth Fold. Good morning. My fucking eyes are going, mate. I'm going from like clear to blurry. Damn. Slag bags. Slag bags. I ain't painting it until you fuck off. Surely you can paint and listen. was making a coffee. He went here all that. And here what? Mine's got a Monero wallet and collect donations through that. Really be very cold in there, North London. Morning, Sophie Tyson. Go and get on me painting. Don't worry about what I'm saying. Don't worry about me. Just pretend I'm not here. Yeah, just pretend I'm not here. Oh no, DJ Normal Norman. That is bad times. Good morning, DB. Good morning to you. Oh dear, DJ Normal Norman. He's got a fucking, he's been sick emoji next to himself. I've got no weed. I've got no weed. What's it? Yes, Adam. Yes, mate. How's it going? How's it going, Adam? Good morning. Monero, what's Monero, man? What the fuck's Monero? Sleek Jacob says, he's right. Monero is quality. What's Monero? A Bailey's or a coffee, technically. I haven't been asleep yet, so don't touch me. Only God can judge me. Too bad. Could be better. Oh, really, mate? Oh, fucking hell, Adam. Well, I hope it gets better, mate. Well, we're all here. All 144 of us. 145, including me. Yeah. Monero, look it up after Brian. Get a cake wallet. The fuck's a cake wallet? Like a wallet shaped like a cake? It's a fucking cake wallet, man. Monero's like a bank account, but untraceable. Ah! You mean like a Monzo? Yeah? I don't get up much. Please hit the likes, says Hassan. Please hit the likes for Brain. Support Brain. Yeah, he's laughed last night at Bob Ross. Ah, did you see that? Yeah, did you like that? Little crimson. Little crimson. Who's at my fucking door? Hold on. There's somebody at the door. 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 There's no one at the door. There's no one at the door. There's nobody at the door. There's nobody at the door. Okay. Well, it's my bloody time. No one at the door. I can only see my own. That's what it's all about. you're right, Hassan. You're not divvy, mate. It's all good. Big up, Brian. That happens a lot. That happens a lot. I should be flattered. Brain. Yeah, we fucking think your brain's amazing. Yeah, you don't. Oh, bless up, Hassan. I'm not having a go at you, mate. I'm not having a go at you. I'm not having a go at you. Have you tried that dispenser roof for your smoke? Quite good. No. What's this? What is this? What is this you say to me? What is this dispenser roof? What is that? Morning, B. Morning, everyone. Rural sound system. It's urban and rural. Rural. Country sound systems. Heard they're quite loud. Brian, you should sing more from your home studio, like some months ago. I will. Probably. I probably will. Can get Smoke Online delivered to your door via Royal Mail. Yeah? Yeah? That was fucking was gonna happen sooner or later, wasn't it? But isn't that illegal? I'm moaning about it. No, well, I'm on it. What? Yeah? Yeah? My sister's claim to fame is that she once kissed you. Can't confirm. Lovely. Can I wait? Lovely. Can't wait for it. What, really? Really? Yeah? I've never heard of it. But we'll look into it. What's it called? What's it called? Like Deliveroo for weed, basically. Is that what it is? Feet, Joe McIntyre. I still love you. Still love you, Brian. Thank you. It's nice to be liked, isn't it? You know? No one really wants to be disliked, do they? You know? Yeah, and Deliveroo are taking legal action against them for the name. But it's different. Well, because of Roo. Well, they copywritten Roo. Copyright Roo. It was delivered to my house via Royal Mail. Package was drenched in oil when it arrived. Postie wasn't impressed. Well, it weren't bloody his, was it? What's he got to do with him? Deliver it. Yeah, it's mad shit. That's fucking mad. Let's have a look at that. What's the deals on there saying? What's it saying? I grew out of weed when I was 25. You don't grow out of it. It's not something you grow out of. You grow with it. You cure with it. Don't worry. What's the doc about Ghislaine? I'm fed up with hearing about her, really. It's just boring, isn't it? You can see where the narrative's going at. Oh, Ghislaine, you know, maybe she was, I think, you know, after her daddy died, you know, she clung on to Epstein like a child. And fuck off, she knew what she was doing, a cunt. I'm some victim, you know what I mean? Your fucking dad's only a multi-fucking billionaire. Oh, poor rich girl. Fuck off. Oh, so bad, so sad. You know, you could have bought a fucking penthouse flat in fucking Chelsea and just sat back and watched your big dirty telly, smoked weed and been happy, but no. You at the traffic fucking children around the world, you cunt. Fucking shit cunt. You know what I mean? What gives you the right to take these children and do what you lot want to do with them? What gives you the right, eh? You know what I mean? You wouldn't like it if you got your fucking face punched in, would you? By people that just felt like, yeah, we feel like we'd do that to you. You wouldn't like that, would you? You wouldn't like that. Same sort of thing, really. You wouldn't fucking like that, would you? Oh, good morning, Bruce. Thanks for tuning in. Such a positive moment. Don't worry, we get them in the end. At least we've got a lot of supporting evidence there in all directions. Phone tapping, Murdoch, child abuse, police corruption. It's all there. It's all there. It's all there. Yeah, you say she's where she deserves, but is she? Because you don't know where she is. I don't think she's in prison. I don't, that's why they showed you drawings. How can she be in prison when she'll have all the video evidence from Epstein on all these fucking dirty bastards? We think they're going to put her in prison after that? No, we're going to show the public that you've gone to prison. We're going to close everything off. No, we can't show the court case on TV. That would be bad. But yeah, we can show you Jenny Dopp, you know. Who likes Jenny Dopp? Do you like Jenny Dopp's acting? Great, isn't she? Yeah, you can watch fucking Johnny Depp and fucking Amber Heard fight their civil case and hear about their fecal matter on the bed. And you know what I mean? That's all right. That's all right. But the one that's in the public's interest, the one that's got to do with the public, really, because that's why we put people away, isn't it? You know what I mean? We can't have you around the public. The one that is in the public's interest, that everyone wants to know about. No, we can't show you that one, because we've got her in a part of America, New York, I think, where, oh, we can't show you the child's on, but you fucking can. You can do what you want. You just don't want to, because it ain't real. It's all lies. It's all lies. And Virginia Giuffre is a lie. And I said it, how long ago? A long time ago. She's liars, mate. No different to Andrew Ash. No different. As real as Puddick being an activist, that is. Yeah. She ain't real. Now she's gonna be there. Oh, you're the trafficker, you're the bad one. Watch, watch, while they keep pushing the narrative of getting a bit of a victim. Mate, don't let him pull that one off, man, please. Right, porridge in paint room. Harvey's fault. My fault. My fault. I keep you from painting. Everybody in a rush to claim Rolf Aru. The main name has already been didgeridoo. No evidence whatsoever she's in prison. No, there ain't no fucking evidence of it. That's what I'm saying. We just get taken for a cunt, and because we see it in on the news and on this one and that one, everyone automatically goes, oh no, well, they wouldn't lie, would they? Would they? Yeah, they would actually. When Prince Andrew and the Jeffrey Epstein sweetheart deal is at stake, you know, then yeah. That's what happened, basically. Andrew came up in a fucking sweetheart deal. My view, my opinion. Because they've gone on so much about, well, you know, we was gonna do that, but Andrew never came up in the thing, so I was like, oh, fuck off, man, I'm not believing that either. Stop it. So just stop with all your lies. Please stop it. Fuck, man, you're confusing me. Oh. You want me to be confused? I get you. You know, it's just all fucking, what way should we go with it? Oh, we can change it at the last minute. You know what I mean? You never quite know where you are with a story. They're bullshit. They're bullshit. There was a problem with a sweetheart deal. From that point onwards, there was always a possibility of Andrew, shit coming out about Andrew. So what did they do? From 2009 onwards, they laid the groundwork for people, stories against Prince Andrew, only for them to get to find out to be false, which was where it was going with Andrew Ash. If you wanted proof of that, why did they call him David on Panorama fucking 2 years later? And then You've heard Andrew 2 years after that in 2018 admitting, oh, Panorama told me to do it, and oh, they chose the name. You've heard it for yourself. You know what I mean? So it's all bullshit. So it's all being done so that they can have Prince Andrew accused by false accusers before that shit hit the mainstream over here. And it was all just before that. And Bill Maloney did say, you know, some of this might come out later on when it's all over, but at least we got it. When what's over? The shit with Andrew. John Harris knew. You know, it's going to be a bit of a shake-up. Well, it was, yeah. He knew, you know, 2 years up front. More than that, I think. 3 years up front, right? But they all knew. And how would they know? Because they'd be intelligence services and they have been told to lay the groundwork for this stuff because it could come on top for Andrew later. And we need at least 3 or 4 stories with him in it, being falsely placed and falsely accused, so that when our one finishes, the Virginia Dufresne, she's now going to be the one who's in trouble. You know, while we slowly over a couple of year period, you know, soften the blow for Ghislaine and turn her into a victim. Whenever she's spoken about on mainstream, yeah, so her relationship with her father, it was a bit bad, was it?
Oh, what, Robert Maxwell, him that jumped off boat.
You know, even Andrew Ash had to fucking push the official fucking Mossad narrative, you know. And the helicopter pilot, 100%, you know, I thought it was Andrew, first of all. It's not, it's Ghislaine.
I think we better leave the helicopter pilot out of it. I think you're right,
says James Fielding from the Express newspaper, who knows Robert Kellaway, who hacked me, and Millie Dowler, who's working there at exactly the same time. Yeah, it's mad, isn't it? It's mad. Mad, mad, mad. But it must be, it's just me, I'm delusional. Like, I just can't help it. I keep finding these things, but they're fucking there, aren't they? Hey, let's be honest, they're there. And I found loads of shit that they never thought that I'd be the type of person to go and check. But yeah, got it all. Screenshots, company's ass, everything. Got you all, got ya, gotcha. Fucking got ya. And now, we're gonna play 5 to 10 years of Let's Suppress Brian. Let's suppress him. We need to come up with something. How can we discredit the man? We haven't done it so far. We've tried though, goddammit. We've tried. You're gonna fucking lose, mate. You're gonna lose. You're gonna lose or I'm gonna die. It's one of them. And I feel fucking lucky. I'm sorry, I'm fucking tired. It's very tired. Oh, fuck off, Siri.
I don't know how to respond to that.
Well, look, I didn't ask for you, so leave me alone. Who turned you on anyway? Go away. Fucking Siri. Grassy. Oh, fuck you. Let me wind up. Oh, rural sound system's laid up with flu. That's because the fucking weather's changed. Get well soon. Q is a psyop at the end of the day, and I agree with you. Because you know what I mean? You had fucking Trump going, you know, at the very tippy top. And it's the Q's gets to get. It's fucking obvious who Q is, isn't it? You know what I mean? He's fucking Trump. He loved Twitter. Fuck off.
How did he know? How did he say?
Because he's fucking him. It's not hard, is it? I'm going to sit there, matter of fact, I can't call myself Q. Yeah. Siri is the mother of Beelzebub. Oh no! Get off my phone. Tommy is Rayleigh Robinson. Yeah, it's not for me, all that movement. Oh, fucking hell, somebody at the door. No, there's not. Damn it, why does he bloody do that? There's no one at the door.
keep messing me around. And then he started saying that I'm working for the New World Order.
Which is true.
This guy. People keep telling me, there's this guy. People, I don't know what it was about a month ago. And people kept saying to me, this guy, Brian Harvey, he's making videos about you. This guy. And then he started saying I was working for the New World Order.
Do you know rung me the other day? A really famous man rung me the other day. Very famous man, probably the only famous man I've got time for. And his name's Joe Pasquale. He's a lovely man. And he rang me the other day to see if I was all right. He got my number off of Nikki the other day because Nikki went to a pantomime that he was in with one of her friends. And yeah, he come on the phone and that, and he genuinely looked pleased to see me. You know, fucking jungle friends. Ah, that's what it was. Was it really? You know, something just comes back to you. Was it really a coincidence that when I went in the jungle, Paul Burrell was there? I don't think it was now, because we know stuff now, don't we, that we didn't know back then. And let's face it, they did hack me while I was in the air on the plane, knew my nan had died, were at the airport at the other end ready to spring it on me. So let's face it, I was being phone tapped at the time. So what I'm saying is they had their radar on me at the time, and then they put a good friend of Tom Watkins's in now, Janet Street Porter, and Paul Burrell, the Royal connection. It's mad, isn't it?
You think you've been asked onto a TV show because it's genuine, and it's not.
Big up Joe Pasquale. Fucking what a lovely geezer he is. You know, just like normal, you know what I mean? Have a fucking normal conversation with him. Lovely geezer, man. I respect him for that. Lovely bloke, man. Lovely bloke. Like when we got in the jungle and that, I gravitated towards him because as soon as I spoke to him, I thought, I like him. And I think he felt the same as well. So he said, I do have one famous friend, yeah. I'm not alone anymore. I'm not alone anymore. Yeah. Don't do drugs, kids. Don't do drugs. Do more. Yeah. Take 15 pills. Yeah. I didn't say which ones I did that. No, don't do that. I'm just joking. It's just a joke, all right? This is the bit they use in the paper tomorrow. What we got? We're just fucking joking. Out of all of that, you picked out that one bit. You fucking can't. That's what they're like, though. That's what they're like. That's what you're up against. That's what they're like. They do that. They do that. The lag's starting with me. It don't bother me no more now. Like, a day in the paper now, he's like, fuck off. I use it against you, bastard. I'll use it against you, bastard. I'll use against you. What is it? Thank you, Adam, mate. Thank you, mate. No, you know, I try to be, didn't I, sometimes. This is not good spirits. This is just fucking, you know, that bit before you go to sleep. That's what that is. Don't get it twisted. I'm utterly depressed. No, I'm all right, I'm all right, I'm all right. I'm all right. That sounded quite like Prince Charles, didn't it? I'm utterly depressed. You're right, Charles. What's going on? Like, can you talk about this Savile thing? I'm utterly depressed. How's it going, Brian? I'm late. Just woke up. Nice to see you live, mate. Thank you, Obi-Wan Kenobi. Wow, is that really you? God, I'm a big fan. Burning the last bit of energy before sleep like a three-year-old. Yeah, that's right, yeah, yeah. I'm not burning energy, though. That's not energy. I suppose it is a form of energy. Yeah, it's my new song, everyone. When performances go wrong. Have you seen that video that I heard on TikTok? She was actually singing, da-da-da-da, lose my mind! Down the mic and that, he's got no bottom t-shirt. Fucking hell, man. Fucking hell. I bet everyone's seen that. Everyone's seen that. You've all seen it. It's come up on all your fucking phones when you've been sitting there in the morning on your phone, going through your messages, having a shit. You've seen it. That's the sort of shit they got for us nowadays. That's what they got for us. I remember, but do you remember the one with the blackbird net sitting on the toilet? Sitting on the toilet. I'm waiting for something to happen, like fucking, yeah, it's mad world, isn't it? It's mad where it's gone. TikTok shorts, YouTube shorts. It's the demise of the world. There's Charles again, utterly depressed since my friend Savile died. And, yeah, but what about your mum and your dad? No. We don't care about it. No, I'm gonna be king. And I'm gonna be king, but I'm gonna have to abdicate. I'm abdicating. I'm gonna be king for a while, but then I'm gonna abdicate. God, this pen, this bastard. Calm down, Charles. Fucking calm down. Bloody pen. This pen. It's going about his fucking fountain pen. Utterly depressed. Since the press started asking me about Savile. Yeah. Okay. Well, I've got to do that. School run. That's it. She's off. I see everyone's like, please come back. There's 150 in here. What do you want? here we go, smoking that energy again. Oh, she's back. She's back. So, is like my my guest today on the show on BHTV is YouTube. Hi YouTube. Now, you mind if I ask you some questions? This is how you turn it around, you see. Can't think of anything to say. Do this. Smoke that energy. Yeah, I got this from Sonia Poulton. Then you haven't seen my film, have you, Brian? You haven't seen my film? I'm just having a go at Sean. Sean, you know, what you've done is wrong. Not talking today, Daddy. Remember that? Yeah, remember that. Not talking today, Daddy. So I'm not going anywhere. You won't be painting for quite a while, I can promise you that. Da 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 da. That's what it sounds like if David Icke does vocals for you. David, it'd be good to do a collaboration. Would you fancy it? Yeah, okay, whatever. What do you want me to do, Brian? I'm not really a rapper, so to speak. I can speak, though, for an incredibly long time, 10 hours. Talk about the nature of reality and any bungle that I can fit in between that looks like it fits with my slideshow here, Sean. In my books, soul. I'll keep me cooked. Oh, it's not the fire. Doesn't fucking work. Bloody hell. Morning, mate. Fucking, I'm getting in and out of focus here. All right, Popeye, nice one, mate, nice one. I was hoping you would help with getting the Rotherham Sheffield grooming gang a voice by interviewing us on how the police and Labour covered it up. Message me if you want. I have to go now. Dawn Shaw. Possibly. That could possibly be one for the future there. You know, I mean, I want to help. I do want to help. But I am going to have to do... We've all heard about, obviously, what's going on up there. And obviously, Tommy Robinson has had a big voice on that. And, you know, if they're nonces and they've done this shit, then, you know, they deserve everything they get, really. Don't matter what colour you are, what religion you are. Grooming gangs in Cornwall, UK cops know. Listen, I get the feeling that this ain't just in these places, it's everywhere. It'll be here, it'll be everywhere. It's gonna be everywhere. So, you know, it's like what I said. How do we do this in one big way where we're covering all areas at once? It means we've got to go in and fucking have the UK police up proper. What have we got, evidence-wise, that embarrasses the police where they should have acted, where they haven't? Well, I've got loads of stuff that we can use as collateral. Phone hacking, Scotland Yard up in the mix on that, Richard Mallett, which leads us into Andrew Ash, and all of this fucking setup, Prince Andrew, so it's obviously all important enough. We need to have the old bill up proper. And I've got evidence to do that. So if my evidence can help smash the police where they're embarrassed and have to listen and have to be seen to be acting, you know, like what they've been doing with, oh, you know, don't arrest a black bloke now because of Black Lives Matter and shit. You see how it's all worked out? Like, same sort of shit here. Same sort of shit here. We need to embarrass the fucking police, show that they've been shit on top of how shit they already look, and embarrass the fuck out of them, and then they'll have to do something about all of it. And it will happen eventually. Let's face it, the story is out there. People do know, and to be honest with you, people do know that the authorities and the government are covering the full extent of it up. Obviously, they've got to show some of it because they've got to look like they're reporting it, haven't they? And that they're fucking genuine. And well, we reported it, didn't we? They want to be able to say that to you, but they won't report the fucking real shit that involves them covering up for their own people. You know, I would say if we could go and sort out all the old white politicians that were fucking nonces and start there first with this VIP abuse ring. Obviously, Jonathan King was supplying to these same people. We never got to know who was in that VIP pedo ring, did we? So obviously they exist, it needs sorting out. And if we can embarrass the police by showing them up with, you know, all about me being phone tapped and all this hacking now, and it's been covered up, and that's why I've not got anywhere, even though I'm in the claims and can prove everything that I'm saying. These are all weapons that can be used against the police to embarrass them. And if that can be added to with, well, we're talking to some people here from Rotherham who have been ignored or had their stories covered up from Rotherham, what are you gonna do about it? You know, so my plan is to hit them at once with fucking everything, but we hit them in a way where the government will have to make it look like they're sacking half of their police and really having a reshuffle, but they won't. They'll just put new of their own people in now and make it look that way. So how are we going to devise a plan to peacefully go in the millions and just say, listen, we've had enough. We're not having your paedophilic fucking madness no more that you've been pushing on us for the past 20 years. We're not having it no more. You're gonna put things back right and you're gonna fuck off. And then we're gonna put people in there we can trust. And all of a sudden, you know, we work out a plan to make the poor rich, and then the poor on par with everyone else. And we can all move forward together. The only reason why people ain't got no money is because the greedy cunts are fucking nicking it all between themselves. Well, if we can get rid of them cunts and show them for what they are and all their ways, so there can be no doubt in these people that we're clearing out, and on top of it, they're paedophiles and all their friends are paedophiles, and they've covered up in these cases for these paedophiles and pulled favours here and this one here and this one here. We can prove all that. We can get them out. And then the only other thing we need to do is stand there 20, 30 million strong, doing nothing, just holding it peaceful to go, this is what you're dealing with. You want to see a united country, all different fucking flavours, colours, everything, mate. We're all there, all of us. That's why we're all the same. All this fucking shit, you got black kids killing black kids on the street. Mate, stop it, man, please. You're walking right into their shit. You know what I mean? They've got you all slagging each other off, calling each other the N-word, killing each other. You know what? You shouldn't do that, man. You should realise that these people are playing a game on you, they're playing a game on everyone, and they've got a little move for every different set of fucking race and people. They've got moves for all of us, all the different people, they've got moves for all of us. But what they don't want is for all of us to go, you know what, it is us against them. And that's all of us, Muslim, Jew, Chinese, Hindu, whatever. All of us, Christians, everyone. That's the only way you're ever gonna win. All the other stuff is just playing into their hands. When we're all killing each other, they're winning. You know what I mean? When blacks are killing blacks over areas and postcodes and stuff, I'm not being funny, but you don't own the area. The council do, right? And it is really a bit ridiculous for killing someone else from another area because they've got to come through that area. They might be going there to see their mate. I mean, it is ridiculous. If we can't move out of barbaric ways of thinking and just playing into their hands, thinking it's cool and credible and clever, it ain't. None of it is. We need to change the way we think. Because the way we're thinking at the minute is just playing into all the little traps that they've got set for all of us in society. But we do need to get rid of the people at the top. They can't be trusted. They've shown us that over and over and over and over again. They can't be trusted. So the move that needs to happen when people are coming in and they're saying, you know, can we do an interview, talk about the grooming gangs and stuff? A part of me does just want to go, you know what, how do we cut straight to the chase here? Because all of this stuff can get talked about properly if we can get rid of the people that are controlling the power networks of the media, all of it, you know what I mean? And the only way to do that is to show them for the paedophiles that they are, and that there's been too many paedophile stories coming out of all of these establishments of power, and that we're simply not having it. And all we ever needed to do was stand together. Stop killing each other, just stand together. And in all the little fucking unfair it is in life, we can sort out, because it won't be them in power no more. It'll be our own people. And collectively, we'll have a responsibility to choose for the first time, realistically, who should be in a prime ministerial position. Because at the minute, it's all done on face value and, oh, we don't know enough about it. You know, they must know what they're doing. They don't. They're wasting your money every year that they're taking off of you in taxes. It's going here, there and fucking everywhere. But yet, they're talking about doing power cuts in the fucking UK. You know, they put food up and energy up when no cunt's got no money. This is what they do. And it's their fucking fault, and we pay for it. And it's not, and you know what? It's the fucking poor people that have all the fucking debts lumped on them. You know what I mean? All the fines and all the fuck. We ain't got it to pay it. Where do you think it's coming from, cunt? Shit, cunt. Where do you think it's coming from, you unreasonable cunt? Fucking makes me sick. It's so simple, but no one wants to sort it out. I'll tell you what, the only fucking way to sort any of this shit out is you better get 40, 50 million of you up off of your fucking arses down to London for one fucking day. One day and one night. One day and one night. Yeah? One day and one fucking night. And it will all change. But you can get 1,000 people down there and they sit there for 4 days, nothing will happen. It'll look good for a minute, 1,000 people, fuck all. If you want it to change, you better get up in your millions, go and stand together, keep it peaceful and say, we're not having you no more, get out. And they'll have to go. And that's the end of it. That's the only way to deal with it. And when a country can sort out all its problems internally, racially, you know, we've all got to be together. We've all got to be together. And there are people, you know, like this whole gay thing has become a big thing in the past 10, 15 years, isn't it? Like, everyone's come out now and now it's a, you know, everyone's gay. you know, even people that are Christians, you know, we're gonna have to accept these things. Right? Now it's not people like me, now that it really puts me in a position, right? And I'm being fucking straight with you. Because the Bible's telling me the gayness is all an abomination. And there's a big part of me that wants to live right by God now. Well, I'm fucking serious. But people can't help who they are, right? I'm not talking about the people that are playing up to this shit, right? I'm not talking about the gay people that are playing up to it, and all that. I'm not talking about them. I'm talking about the people that just, you are gay, right? You fancy the same sex as you. Right, that's basically what it means, doesn't it? Yeah, that's what it means in this day and age, anyway. And if that is genuinely who you are, and it's not a facade, and it's not being done to just rebel, and that is who you are, then that is who you are. Who the fuck can tell you who you are? Yeah, and these books have been changed so much. The Bible, there's so many fucking versions, right? So I'm not gonna go against God, but I'm gonna be astute enough to know that I thought God's supposed to be about love. You can't tell me he's about love and then he's not really, he's about hating. He's about, it done, none of this is making any sense. Like, were you telling me space goes on forever? No, it don't. No, it don't. Though you're lying. None of this makes sense. None of it makes sense. You are who you are. And if someone wants you to be who you're not, it's wrong in anyone's fucking book, in my fucking view. I believe in God and I love, you know what I mean? And I love God and I hope he loves me. And I feel that is, it's got to be the essence of our change, innit? Getting over yourselves, not being embarrassed and showing more love. But it's very hard to show love to people like Ian Puddick, isn't it? In my particular example, it's very hard to show love to someone like Rupert Murdoch, Ghislaine Maxwell, you know what I mean? So they're the sort of things that I'm gonna, you either gotta be one or the other, ain't you? You know, and I don't want to be a fucking walking contradiction. People are people, you know, whether you're Jewish, whether you're gay, whether you're Muslim, whether you're Christian, people are people, and you can't fucking change that. All we can do is learn to understand each other a bit more, except for paedophiles, don't get it fucking twisted. There's no room for that. No fucking room for that. Right, please understand that. There's no room for that. There never will be. You're never gonna get a family, happy family, kids going to school, kid comes home 4 o'clock after school and that, oh, we're just gonna get Roy round. He's gonna see you for a little while, right? 46-year-old Roy's gonna pop round. It's all right, yeah, with your kid, your 8-year-old. Who is ever gonna be all right with that? No one. So it ain't gonna work, is it? It's not gonna work. Their paedophilia fucking normalisation thing, it ain't gonna work. They're trying it though. They're trying it, but it ain't gonna work. It ain't never gonna work. There's no parents are ever gonna be like, all right, see you later. Make sure he gives a call when he wants to pick you up, all right? All right then, all right, see you later. You're gonna let your 8-year-old go off of a fucking 67-year-old now. Oh, don't worry, she'll be all right with me. Come on, go on. You know what I mean? It's never gonna run, never. Never, it's never gonna run. It's never gonna become normal, it's not. They're really trying to breed normality out of us, aren't they? Being normal. They're really trying to, like, hey, don't worry, a couple of generations, it'll be gone. They really fucking believe that, don't they? Dickheads, man. You pervert cunts. You're perverts, mate. You're fucking perverts of the worst degree. Fucking perverts, man. Telling kids and that you know, you can be a little good, you fucking evil bastards. No, you need stopping. You're gonna get stopped. This won't go on for much longer. People will rise up, they will. As soon as it starts affecting you lot all out there personally, you will. But the thing is, you'll do it in the wrong way and you'll kick off and smash things up, and then they'll use that against you and say, well, you can't be fucking trusted as a nation, you know, we're not going to let you have fucking power. You know, you've really got to fucking pull it out of the bag here, man. So, you know, a fucking year's worth of, right, this is what we're going to do in a year. We're going to do this, we're going to do it. So it really needs a fucking big fucking following behind it. And then in a year's time, everyone just goes, crash, we're fucking here, we're doing it, we're doing it. We're getting these cunts out. It's the only way. Or just keep believing their dribble and their lies for the next, well, the rest of your life, really. You know, we don't live that long. Can we waste any more time listening to their lies and their, you know, we aim to do better and fuck off, you cunt. You're not going to do nothing better but learn to nonce better. That's all you're going to do.
We promise we will nonce better in the future and do a clear and concise job of it.
Fucking all talk like robots, you're all mugs. Mugs. Talk like fucking robots. What is the point of you? What have you become? You was human once, you used to have a laugh. Now, okay, sir, do you want to stand over there? Must be horrible. Must be horrible. Must be horrible. You must have really got beat up hard in life to want to go and be old Bill. 45 degrees. My arms go out at 45 degrees and then handcuffs went on them. Thank you, Nikki. My beautiful queen. Kenneth Noel Curran, online child protection, whilst they groom children with education. Education, save our children, UK and elsewhere. Petition for Declan's Law. Stop abuse, stop child abuse, exploitation. I mean, does anyone not know about fucking, you know, child abuse in the world now and child trafficking? Is there anyone out there that don't fucking know now? It's just like, you used to hear about it, now it's all the time, 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 all the time. But, you know, we are getting closer, I believe, to, you know, we can't fucking do that no more. Like, it's going to be, I reckon we can get there. In the way that they made you wear a fucking seatbelt, we can make these cunts fucking stop doing what they're doing.
Well, no, you know, we used to be able to do it, we can't do it anymore because, you know, you've got the new things coming to play now, or new laws and...
You know that shit. Like, people fall for it, don't they? They have it.
Oh, yeah, we've got to wear a seatbelt now, it's a fucking £50 fine.
You know what I mean? Starts off like that. That's what we need to do to them.
You know, can't be a nonce no more in Parliament, you know, they do checks now.
You know what I mean? We need to turn it round on these cunts. When are we going to turn it round? Then we're going to stop killing each other. Yeah, get on. Get rid of these mugs that are over there like, you know, he said something about your mum. That's what the government are. They're people like, oh, excuse me, mate. That bloke over there, he called your mum a cunt. Oh, I'll see you later, bye. Yeah, that's what the government are. That's what they're doing, basically, in layman's terms. That's what they're doing. And everyone's fucking having it.
Yeah, well, fucking, we think this and we think that.
Edged along by their own people doing the arguing, then the public get involved. Yeah, well, fucking, you know what I mean? You can see how it escalates. It's bungle. Stop listening to these nonces. Everything they tell you on the news, reverse it or take the opposite from what they're telling you. And that will be the truth 9 times out of 10. Yeah. It's mad. That's how I've ended up looking at them now. That's a lie. That's a lie. That'd be a lie because of that. That's a lie because of that. You can see through them. They're never going to tell you the truth. Ever. So get up off your bums. What's happened here? Why is there a picture locked up? It's locked up on my phone. Why have you done that? Oh no. Thank you for encouraging broadcast. Thank you, Kenneth. Yeah. Listen, like, honestly, I've thought about this shit. I've thought about it a lot. And it's like, I really would love things to change for the better. You know, like all poor people not worrying about keeping warm and having money and worrying about the basics of life. Like, surely with all this technology we've got and all this fucking shit we know and all this stuff we can do, we can't get those people out of trouble. We can't get, you know, people like myself and people much worse off than me. I can moan, but I know there's people worse off than me, much worse off than me. And my kitchen's fucked. I ain't got no kitchen in. It's all fucking ripped out. You know what I mean? There's people much worse off. Much, 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 much worse off. Ain't got a computer. You know what I mean? Couldn't even fucking have the electric to keep the fucking computer. I'm telling you, like, there's people out there going through it. Every time I moan about my situation, now do I feel bad? I sit down and think, fucking hell, you know, like, and it's like, no, there are people worse off. I go back to my car accident, not being able to walk up the stairs and all that, and now I'm just, like, I'm about, you know what I mean? I'm fucking, I'm about. So, you know, there's people out there much worse off and they're really having it fucking hard. And I don't see why are we getting tortured in life? Why, well, we can't keep fucking warm, and it's like, fuck's sake, man. Put the blow heater on the man, for fuck's sake. Why are you doing this? It's so unnecessary, all of it. Just greedy fucking paedophile, fat fucking bastards. Yeah, that need to go. Stop being scared of them, let's fucking get rid of them. Next year, let's fucking do it, please. Let's do it, I'm ready when you are. I'm fucking bored anyway. I'm fucking ready, mate, when you are. Yeah, when you want to call this one on, fucking let's do it, mate. I'll come. I'll be there, mate. I will be there. Oh, here we go. Fucking front door again. Just to get fucking no one there. Here we go. Look, fucking no one. Fucking bollocks, isn't it? Yeah. See, fucking picture's locked up again now. Oh, you bastard. There we are. Nah, is it my fire? It's fucking not on. It could be worse. Could it? Little boys turn into little girls turn into little boys. Could it? Not much worse. Being run by paedophiles. Got a king whose best friend was a fucking... The biggest, prolific, most prolific paedophile necrophiliac in the country. Could it be worse? 250,000 kids a year go missing in the UK alone. Could it be worse? Yeah, Balenciaga, you know, and then Chanel. Look at the fucking... I swear I got a picture of it. The guillotine. Now, why the fuck would Chanel need to make a guillotine? One of their silly fucking fashion parties and that, and then they got a fucking child in there, and then... I just want to kill these cunts. But you can't. You've got to catch them. Fuck is it? Fuck the type picture of it, I'm sure. This is our magic night focal length. Fuck that type of picture. Oh, fucking hell. Oh, mate. Right. Someone want to tell me what's happened here with Simon Cowell? What the fuck is going... You can't see that, that's blurred, isn't it? What is going on there? What the fuck has happened? If that don't look like a demon now, I don't know what does. You can't really see that properly, can you? I'd have to dim the screen down. Honestly, it's like fucking... Look. Oh, you can't see, it's blurred there. Cause... It's unbelievable. I don't, you ain't gonna ever see that. Shocking. That is shocking, shocking, shocking. And let me try and... Can you see that? Getting that? Fucking hell, that's ropey, isn't it, eh? That's what we're all looking up to, look. Everyone's looking up to him, eh? No fucking bleeping. Where the fuck is that come from? No, seriously, that is a mess. It's Simon Cowell. Hello. What has happened? You tell me that looks fucking right. He looks like he's melted. He looks like he's got AIDS and pumped his face out with a load of plastic in a bid to try and recapture his youth. Still look up to him? A fucking demon! There's a demon in there. There's a demon pretending to be God in there. Look at him. Fucking state of that. Imagine that weight down next to you. Oh, mate, that's fucking... that's fucked. I've got sound coming out of his phone or something. I keep getting mad bleeping. Maybe I've got the sound up or something. Yeah. Oh, no, I'll wait. So it looks like Noel Edmonds sacked the surgeon. No, but I mean, come on, what has it come to where people are doing that to their face like it's normal? It started there, didn't it? That's where the weirdness started. Oh, I'm just doing this. No. Ah. I'm just doing this. Michael Jackson. Fucking. Fucking hell. Yeah, he's fucked it and he's fucking hell. All that money and he's. He's fucked it, mate. He fucked it. He looked half normal once. I mean, even then, his fucking jeans were up where his tits are. Fucking man. What is happening to these people? And everyone's like, well, Simon Cowell, fucking bit. What? Nah, man. Simon Fowell. He's definitely not got the X Factor anymore. Fucking hell. It's horrifying, isn't it? It's a fucking horror show. Fucking catch him in the fucking passage in the middle of the night with a fucking oil lamp going for a piss. Like that fucking painting, remember that painting? He was fucked. Do you like Christmas, Brian? I used to. Not anymore. Let me interview you, Brian. Why? What do you want to freeze that ugly thing? Is he freezing? Is he freezing his fucking self? Louis Walsh is another fucking one. Knock him.
I like it, Simon, I like it.
So, Louis, what do you think of my thing?
I like it, Simon, I like it.
Fuck you, look, fuck you, cunt. You'll never go at me and that. Oh, Brian, you know, you're not doing too well. And that. Fucking look better than you, you cunt. Fucking hell. See that about discount, not Stuart, Pimlico plumber. You see about discount, Rod Stewart, that Pimlico plumber. No, I ain't seen that. No, not seen that. I only got a big photo, yeah, so sure. The Scream, Van Gogh. Yeah, I think that's what it is, The Scream. I remember I had to fucking write something about that, what I thought was going on in the picture when I was in fucking infant school, I think. There's two men, two shadows in the background, if I remember rightly. Might have even drew it.
I like it, Simon. I like it.
We have a big problem with nonces in our community and culture. You have seen it firsthand from different angles. Not from that fucking angle, I didn't. Would like to get the insight for the community.
Yeah, it's a pain in the arse being in the music business.
I'm tired. No, be serious now. My arm's got it, 45 degrees. We do have a big problem. I've been talking about it for a long time. Seen the government cover it up firsthand. With the old, BBC, their government, the Express newspaper, the Mirror, journalists, Panorama, people that work directly for the Queen, i.e. Ian Puddick, podcasters, going along with these people's narratives as well. Ian Puddick, John Wedger, Sean Atwood. It's a problem. It's a problem. It is a battle between good and evil. Because there's nothing good about people that want to fuck children. There can be nothing good about that, ever. So, I don't see why we should have to be made to feel, we need to understand them and that. I don't want to understand them. I want them to fucking die. You can't have them about. Why do you want them about hurting the kids? Because you lot are like it, your fucking selves. That's why. That's why. Of these fucking judges and that, they're nonces. Even the judge you had on my case. Nonce, and nonce protector. I don't mean now. No, I just thought I'd fucking clear that up for y'all. Something's got to be done, you know what I mean? But like, we all talk backwards and forwards. Nothing happens, it gets worse. What are we going to do? What are we going to do? If someone can come up with a better plan than calling an event shush, where it means that's what's been going on, a lot of fucking shush covering up with shit, keep your mouth shut, everyone knows that one, yeah? And on the day, everyone just shush, just be there. Just be there in solidarity and shush. And we know that way also, that was me foolproofing the agent provocateurs. Because if anyone's shutting their mouth off, you eject them from, I wouldn't like to be ejected from a 20, 30 million people crowd for being the one that was like, hold it down, mate, we're trying to make a point here. I wouldn't want to be that one. You know, and I thought that's a good way to safeguard agent provocateurs, because you're going to get them. But agent provocateurs have got to make noise, haven't they, to agent provocateur. So if you called the event Shush, imagine that, 30 million people all over the main part of fucking London, all candled off, all there, all fucking night. Or making a pact to be here, we're going to be as long as it takes, you are going. How are you going to argue with that lot? That's the only way, man. Otherwise, they're just going to put, oh, you know, we've got a new head of police now, you know, fucking Crusader fucking Dick, you know, has gone. I wonder why. I bet you was at Boris's party. That's why you had to go. Change it. Nothing's changed, has it? Policing got better, has it? Paedophiles been caught. Got better since Crusader Dick's gone, and I don't even know who's in her place. As your government, Rishi Sunak, I don't know any of these people. I'm not involved. You know, when you got Donald Trump and Boris Johnson in as your main people, you know, it's entertaining sometimes a little bit, you know what I mean? But it's bored now, like, fuck it, Liz Truss, what? I'm a fighter, bye. Fucking see you later then. Yeah, get your pension, didn't you? You good? She's good. She's good. Rishi, you know, just get a fucking multi-billionaire in there who don't fucking need it. You know, you can really relate to the people, Rishi. Nice one, Rishi. It'd be fucking gone soon when he... when are we going to have someone with substance? We're not. They'll get someone that will pretend to have substance. They'll do that. And then they'll support an illegal war. Weapons of mass destruction. It's just all fucked, mate. At least it ain't going to change till you get rid of them. So there you go. There you go. There you go. There you go. 100%. They've put Hancock. Yeah, there you go. It's all spin and Hancock on what? The jungle? Ooh, the fucking jungle. Listen, Matt Hancock gave 30 million quid to a pub landlord. Do you remember? To give out what? The sheets or stuff to do with the COVID? 30 million quid to your pub landlord. Well, that cunt don't know something about you, and that's why you've had to pay him off. Shut up. Didn't just say that, did I? Shut up. 30 million quid to your fucking pub landlord. Food banks. 30 million quid to your pub landlord. For what? What's he got, fucking shit on you? It's just all wrong. It's all wrong. All of it. But I like moaning about it, you see, I love it. I love moaning. So I'm getting old now. Fucking love a moan. Love a fucking moan. Got 147 people in the room. We've only lost 3 people. I've been talking complete shit. We've lost 3 people. It's not bad, is it? It's good, man. Like, even like with Nicky Cooper's account, it's like people aren't even bothering trolling, are they? They're not even bothering. I'm looking through, it's like, oh, hang on, we had someone timed out. All right, who's this? That story. Who are you? Who are you? Ooh, that story. Oh, that story. Hide user on this channel. Bye. It was nice. It was nice, though. It was a short relationship, but it was a nice one. And she's gone. Thank you, Leslie Wallace. Yeah, someday. Someday. It'll probably be legal one day, and we can all, you know, fucking... have a puff outside Downing Street. Brian Mildrew. This I've got plenty of fucking moan about. All right. Yeah, do a live with Nikki soon and Lee. Yeah. It's only because me kitchen, like, I'm just want to get on top of this. I need to get it sorted out. And I'm on it now. You should see my front garden. Fucking hell. And outside the front garden. It's bad times, man. But I think they're coming today. To pick it all up. So, and that's got to go before I can get the rest of the kitchen out. Before it can be plastered and... Yeah, man, these mice have caused me problems, serious fucking problems. And it's cold. It's cold. I've got hiccups. Yeah. It's going to be a shit one this year, you know what I mean? Like, I accept that. Like, ass ain't how it needs to be and that, but I've got to start the process. So, yeah, it's only another day anyway. Christmas, listen, Jesus weren't born at Christmas, so Christmas don't mean fuck all to me no more. It don't mean nothing. It's just another day. If anything, it's just a... But we all know it. It's just a big con to get us to buy, to consume. That's what it is. It's about the money. It's not about goodwill and fucking peace and Jesus, the birth of Jesus. It weren't born then. It weren't born then. It's pagan, and it's got child sacrifice in its past, Yule log. It was a terrible time, a time of a bit like the fucking purge. Do what you like for however long that holiday was. It was called Christ Mass, and it weren't fucking good. It was having sex with kids, animals, you know, anything went. So no wonder they kept it going. But now they get us to buy each other things, yeah? Buy each other gifts. I'd like to give you this gift. Because it's what I'm supposed to do. If I don't do it, I feel guilty. That's what it is. That's what they've installed in you all. Feel guilty. I haven't got it, you know what I mean? I ain't got it. I can't do fuck all. And they cut me money down. I can't do fuck all. Just trapped here in this existence, just sitting in this house and not really going anywhere, just remembering things you have done to make yourself feel better about not doing anything now. And that's all there seems to be, really. There's nothing else. It's fucking shit, isn't it? And it's not like there's any encouragement from, you know, anyone in any fucking area of life, doctors or no one. No one gives a fuck about nothing. Everyone's just sitting about waiting to die. I love these chats. Yeah. That's it. There you go. Merry Christmas. Yeah, I used to be known for Christmas once. Stay another day. I'm just glad I ain't got all the pressure of keeping up with it. Ooh, we've got to fucking turn the lights on. We've got to fucking do that bollocks to it, mate. Fuck all of it. Fuck getting on planes. Fuck, I've had 3 hours sleep and everyone's at my door to fly to Russia at 6 o'clock in the fucking morning. Nah, bollocks. Bollocks. Fucking keep it. Keep it. I can do it soon, Dan. Yeah, steam. There's no need to be afraid, Brian. Sean. Steam, Sean. Yeah. 172 in the room now. Okay, now. Yep. Ball. Enciaga. Do what thou wilt shall be the whole of the law, said Alistair. It's one hell of a come down. Oh, fucking hell, I fucking depressed you all now. Go on, go on. Nah, you're right. It's fucking, come on, I'm only being real. You know, I still have happy times. I'm still, it's a dinner, isn't it, really? It's at Christmas. You know, I'm gonna fucking cook that with that. I don't know, but it's possible. Potatoes in the air fryer. Turkey crown in the mini oven, not a microwave, a mini oven, mini fan oven. It's got a couple of hobs on top of it. Oh yeah, that's how I'm rolling. It's a Cookworks. Yeah. That's me. But I can do it. Potatoes, I done some roast potatoes in the air fryer the other day to test it out. And I threw the sprouts and chestnuts thing in with it. I'd put the sprouts on and the chestnuts thing, I'd throw that in the air. I'd put it in with it, yeah? But I done it, I need to do it a little bit later and fucking come out perfect. So roast potatoes in the air fryer, banging. Fucking not dirty knob of butter in now. You ain't got to part boil them or nothing. Just fucking whack them in there, man. Wash them, cut them up, bung them in there. Salt and pepper, a bit of butter. And fucking leave them to get on with it. And then later, tip the fucking, the sprouts and the things in there with it. About 15 minutes from the end. That's that bit sorted. Yeah, and then you've got two hobs on top of the thing there. So I suppose you could bung peas and carrots in one. And something in the other. Fuck knows, you know, peas, carrots. We've got roasted parsnips, that's a roasted thing. Have to cook the meat, take it out, do a Yorkshire mix, pre-done in the fucking fridge, in the Nutribullet, ready to just fucking whisk it up again, but cold, and put it into hot fat. In that, when I've taken the turkey out, you know, I've got to fucking time it right. But it's doable. So that's me this year. And then before you know it, in the blink of an eye, it was all over. And it was January again. And then it started getting hot again. And then we was all fucking roasting, trying to get air conditioners. Can't be cold enough. It's too fucking hot. Nah, fucking freezing. You know? I suppose you get bored of living when you get to about 80 odd or something, and it's like, fucking hell. It's the fucking same thing. It's Groundhog Day every day, innit? It's just the same shit. And you just gotta keep yourself occupied in the middle, in between it all, so you don't get bored. I think that's the secret. Because it's just monotonous, innit? It's fucking same shit. Year after year. I'm gonna do this next year. Don't fucking do it. You know what I mean? It's all a load of bollocks. We're all lying to ourselves. Let's stop lying to ourselves. Let's change, yeah. I'm fucking tired. Still, 186 of you. You know, I think it's all right, don't I? We're winning. We are winning. It's a stormy weather. 30 million in Leicester Square. You know that. So we are. Oh, 30 million. Can you imagine that? Look, what that looked like. 30 million people. You know, we're coming to you live from the eye in the sky. And fucking look down and see that lot, man. 30 million people. Not getting railed up and that, just there. Oh, that's all you got to do, just there. Someone up the front, go and get it. That's it, that'd be the fucking end of it. What do you think they're going to do to 30 million of you? Turn guns on you and like, what do you think they're going to do? They're going to know it's over. And if they don't leave, we'll stay there until they leave. They're not going to want 30 million, it will disrupt everything, but it will be a worthwhile, a worthwhile disruption because they let a fuck off. I mean, if someone's got a better idea that ticks all the boxes, it's got to be peaceful, otherwise we're no better than them, right? It's got to tick all the boxes. We've got to be together, we've got to keep quiet, we've got to show these people, even though we could just go in there and turf them out if we wanted to, but we ain't setting the example then, are we? It's got to be done right. And the only way to do it right is somehow you'd have to get 30 million people to just, in solidarity, knowing the coup from a year up front, like, how this has got to be. And if you're going to get involved, get down there. Promote it for a year and do it. So you got a year. You know what I mean? You got a year to get out. We're coming. 30 million of us. It'd be over. It'd be over. Demand a new government. And the people form one. And then we put the people through checks. Every single person through checks. Check their background and all that. Because we want people, most people are good, I think. I think most people are good, really. I don't think most people are, you know, some people go out their way to be bad. But I think most people are good, really. They want to feel good. They, you know, it's, you're not, you wouldn't be used to having any good treatment, I suppose, you know what I mean? Like, I think the world hates you. But, you know, we should be able to change all that. I don't see why not. I really don't. It just makes all the conversations that people have, all the debates, to me, just pointless. It's like, how do we cut to the chase? That's how you do it, 30 million people. It's possible, but I doubt I'm the speaker to, what's the word? To put it all to them. You know what I mean? Because they'd knock me straight away. Oh, you had mental health, you're not listening to him. You know what I mean? I mean, but you get someone who really can articulate the problems properly, you know, and I'm sure we can change it. I'm sure we can. 30 million, yeah. And then you can all buy my album. No, don't worry about that. My book, in my books, I talk about how I rallied 30 million people together and we changed the world. Is the sound all right still? It is, yeah. City of London, Head of the Snake, yes. A good alien invasion, that's what we need. Where's a bloody good alien invasion when you need it? Listen, don't put it past them, man. They got that shit all fucking ready for you. Yeah, they got all that. You think they ain't thought about that one, doing that one to you? When they get desperate enough, they'll drop it. Oh, the UFO. Did you see it over Trafalgar Square? What shape was it? Oh, it was a triangle shape, I think. Oh, it's not. Not hot at all. Oh, fuck off, man. Were you having a laugh already? You ate that money already, you fucking cunt. You fucking cunt. I take a piss. Morning, Humble Crumble. Peasants revolt. Oh, fucking Schofield, what's he done? Is he fucking at it again? Oh, let's all watch the nonce this morning. Let's all watch the fucking rakey nonce. Fucking sick of these cunts. They'll turn the piss out of you. In the break and that, they're in the back going, oh, what, yeah, ready, go. And they go out and read their auto cue. Fucking, I can't stand more. Fucking takes a piss out of it, you cunt. Fucking cunt. That's a fucking joke. That is a fucking joke. Yeah, man. Can we hurry up and get rid of these fucking people, please, so we can all get back to just fucking living without... fucking electric. Fucking sick of this, man. Sick of it. Sick of it. All you want is money from people that ain't fucking got nothing. Fuck off and die. Fuck off and die, you noncy, greedy cunt. Fuck off. Man. God, it's so unfair. It's just both bollocks, isn't it? Honestly, when you start thinking about it like that, I might sound like I'm a fucking moany cunt, yeah? But it's true. There's no need for none of this. None of it. All this fucking technology, iPhones and all that, sitting here like, you know what I mean? It's bullshit. This ain't looking after your people. Fuck you. While you little fucking run around in your fucking rich suits and that, looking down on us and that, like, we're fucking nothing, you cunt. Cunts. And we got to put up with that. Charles's mate's a nonce. Prince Andrew's mate's a nonce. Fucking secret tunnels from Buckingham Palace. VIP rooms made up behind secret walls in nightclubs with corridors off of it with fucking beds like that. Drawings of a woman who's supposed to be going for a fucking trial. Fuck off. Happy Christmas, everyone. Happy Christmas, happy Christmas. And every mother's child is gonna spy. I'm not bipolar. It's fine. Oh, yeah. Art in Embassies. Yeah, that's Art in Embassies. That is going to be Nicky Cooper, you know what I mean, needs to take the credit for that one. Arts in Embassies. Yep. Keep coming off the live. My picture keeps locking up. We will not comply. Yeah. All right, let me just, I need another coffee. What's the time here? All right, yeah, we can do another little. We're doing a little half hour. Fucking alarms going off. Got them fucking drilling out the front, digging up half the fucking road. Happy Christmas, everyone. Happy Christmas. Oh, what was I doing? I was doing something. What was I doing? See if we've got a lot. So I fucking, I'm trying to change the, let's see what we got over here. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, definitely need another coffee. Oh yeah. It's got the reverb, right? Reverb down, yeah. Oh yeah. Reverb. See if we've got any other songs in there. What we got? See if we can find. Let's see if we can recreate. No, that's not the one. That's not the one. Where's the original? Give me the original. Give me the original. got it in here. I do like this one. But I really do love the original. I can't find it. Stay original, it's alright. It's alright, hold on. Nope, not now.
Find it hard to sleep tonight. Santa's on his way.
Lots of toys and goodies. Today's Christmas. Yeah. Still trying to find the original though. This one. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. All right, we let 'em come again. We're gonna go again. Now we got it sorted there. One, two, one, two. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, just a bit better. Get it Christmassy for you. Yeah. And you know what? We can do it all through a fucking radio mic. And my electric needs topping up in the background. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Bomber clock. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow. You've sung it wrong, you fucking idiot. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on a sleigh, and every mother's child is gonna spy to see a reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Though it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. Your bumper clot, please buy my song. I'm not really selling the song. It's just a joke. else will fucking sit here and do this for you, eh?
Oh, I love this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's Gary Barlow.
This is a tune, mate. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to
there you go. Is that fucking Christmassy enough for you? Yeah, we do it live. We do it live.
Should we do it again? Let's do it again. Let's try and get it better. Let's get it all Nat King Cole like he did it. He just sat there all smooth, hardly moving though.
Ta-da. Hang on, is that going to loop round? Hopefully it's going to loop round. Just waiting.
It should be. It might be a... Can't get a staff these days. You know, these pop stars, these one-man bands, they will try and do it all on their own, you know. God, there's loads of fucking spareness on the end of that track. Right, here we go, one last time. In the key of Nat King Cole. Right. Right, it was smooth, wasn't it, yeah? Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe.
Got the fire, the fire.
Help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see a reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. You're such a moany bastard. Christmas winter wedding. Out to the public. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas. To... Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. All right? We'll stop moaning now. Right, I'm going to play something else now. I'm going to play something else. I don't know why I started singing old songs. I must be getting old. Must be getting old. It's just, I like some of them now. I never used to. What else we got here? I'm gonna play this because I like it. This is such a tune. Yeah, 1, 2. Forever, forever. So much to me, there's nothing more precious than to raise a family. If there's any doubt in your mind, you can count on me. I'll never let you down, lady. So far in love. Now our baby is born, healthy and strong. Now our dreams are reality. Forever, my lady. Forever, my lady.
It's like a dream.
I'm still waiting, baby.
I'm holding you close, you're keeping me warm. If this is ecstasy. There's no me or no you, no what will we do? An awful sight to me. If I am you, tell me where would I go? Oh, life had no meaning, and I pray that you'll always stay with me. You and I. Now our dreams are reality. Forever, my lady.
It's
like a dream.
Yeah.
I'm holding you close, you're keeping me warm. If this is ecstasy.
Forever, my lady.
I say it's part of me.
I'm still waiting, baby.
Yeah.
felt so far in love. Baby is born, healthy and strong. Now our dreams are reality. Forever my lady, I'm still waiting, babe. Forever my lady. What tune, man? I think it's got to be one of my favourite tunes ever. It's got to be. Such a tune, man. Big up Joe to sing. It's not a Christmas song, but it's a fucking brilliant song. And I like it. What else we got here before I go to bed? Must have something. Must have something. Let's see if I can do the verses of this. Just the verses, right? Let's see if I need to get a rapper in. 1, 2, check. Yeah. 1, 2, 1, 2. Yeah. Come on. One to the two, to the three, to the... Call me for the pleasure, you can call me for the pain. Call me on the phone or on the mental plane. I'll be the freak you need, I contain what you came for. Come about, come as I destruct the dance floor. Ride to the top, never stop, drop like cream. And I'll bring the steam. Yeah, you bring the body and I'll bring the steam.
Love to love you.
Love you.
Love to heal you.
Love can see you. Love can feel you. Come on. Oh baby, yeah. Love will help you. Love won't harm you. Steam. There's no need to be afraid. Let the link of love unfold. Tonight let's become one soul. Yeah, 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 yeah. Come on. 1, 2. Yeah. Check. Yo. Steam like a cream dream, never stop rising. I rub you like a wave going out while the tide's in. Pressure bubblicious, hard and nice and easy. Smooth with the move to soothe, dry or greasy. Here is your harmony, here is your friend. Kindred, spirit of ethereal blend. Meet me on the cloud or on the journey, sure. I'll take your body on a mystery tour.
Love you.
Love you.
Love you.
Yeah,
come
on. Love can see you. Love can feel you. Come on.
Come on.
Oh, baby. Love will help you, love won't harm you, steam. Yeah, come on, come on, steam, yeah. Steam, come on, yeah. Steam, steam, come on, you going with it? Yeah, yeah. Yeah. The clock upon your wall is ticking slower and slower. Time disappears as I go lower and lower. I know you're fighting fantasy, but I can repeat that. Doubting about me, bet you that I defeat that. I'm your spiritual dancer, your emotion enhancer. The way you wanna go, over, below, or on top. I love you down, all around, in and out, and all about. I'm gonna be drinkable deep, or I'm your lover, none. Stop. Blood, blood. Shout out to the Christmas crew. Hey? Yeah.
There's no need to be afraid. Let the link of love unflow. Tonight let's become one soul. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ooh. Yeah, yeah.
outside is raining, but inside is wet, like your mum's tits. Like your mum's tits. See what I did there? No, of course I didn't. All right, this is going to be what we got. Must have a last one there for you. Last one. Easy one, yeah? Easy one. One that's easy for me. Because it's early.
One, two, one, two.
Trying to see if I remember the verse. Right, this is the last one, yeah? Last one. Yeah. Come on. Yeah. Like your mum's tits. Check it, yeah. Turn the lights low. Put some music on. Let our body scene swing into the soft song. I feel your heat, it's turning me on. I wanna feel ya all night long. So come close as you can. I surrender, you're so tender and tan. I wanna toss, I wanna tumble, feel and fumble. I wanna do it till my belly rumble. So lay back and close your eyes. And while I feel, you can fantasize.
Yeah, we're going deep, baby. I like sleep sugar.
So rest up on my chest.
Yeah, we're going deep, baby.
Deep down.
I like sleep sugar.
So rest up on my chest.
Yeah, we're going deep,
deep down.
I like sleep sugar.
So rest up on my chest.
Yeah, we're going
deep,
deep down. I like sleep sugar.
Yeah. I wanna kiss you from your head to your toes. Then I wanna lick you where you love me to go. Yeah, oil your skin within, hold you tight. Yeah, I'll butter the toast if you lick the knife. And then I take a shower, maybe bubble the bath. I was yours, you was mine, yeah, we'll have a good laugh. I'll be the sponge will wash you down. Then I'll be the towel upon your naked body wrapped around. Then as our games come to an end, we'll start again, yeah, we'll start again.
Yeah, we're going deep, baby.
Deep, deep down.
I like sleep sugar.
So rest up on my chest.
Yeah, we're going deep, baby.
Deep, deep down.
I like sleep sugar.
So rest up on my chest.
Yeah, we're going deep.
Deep, deep down.
I like sleep sugar.
So rest up on my chest.
Yeah, we're going deep.
Fucking, what's the time? Look, it is 9:45. It was like in the 7 o'clock, man, when I was sitting here first talking to you lot. So, yeah, I think it's time to hit the bed now. But I will more than likely come back on a bit later on tonight. Probably with something to say this time, because literally I just wanted to come on, have a couple of coffees with y'all, have a spliff and go to bed. And on that note, I'm going to bid you good night, and I will more than likely see you later. If I don't see you later, I will be back on soon, and me, Lee, and Nikki are going to have a vodka night. And yeah, because they always go well, and they always last about 8 hours. So get prepared for that one. That one's going to be coming soon, yeah? I promise you. Until then, good morning, good Christmas, and have a nice time, and I'll catch up with you a bit later, all right? Bless up.